Why all of these states of emergency around the country?
We understand in the state of emergency, Sergeant Fifield, that all officers, even if they're detectives, have been called to the street in anticipation of this.
Travis County leaders have already issued a disaster declaration to ensure first responders are able to better manage what's to come.
Texas County issued a disaster declaration to try to prepare for the solar eclipse.
It says it is enacting the state of emergency out of an abundance of caution, as it has been working with partners to ensure April 8th runs as smoothly as possible.
Next up, it's Coryell County, who has issued a local disaster declaration all ahead of the solar eclipse on Monday. The county is expecting up to 200,000 visitors. That would cause a real burden on the infrastructure there. Disruption of cellular and internet services as well, and grocery and fuel shortages can be expected. Residents are urged to have sufficient food and groceries for days leading up to and post the big event.
We will be activating the city's emergency operations center here in City Hall, as well as a joint information center.
At a joint news conference Tuesday, city leaders said the focus is on fun and public safety.
We're going to continue to do more through the city of Dallas. We're going to do more in District 4, and here is the celebration.
Dallas coverage may be a challenge that day. While we are surging resources in terms of additional coverage, and while we are basically expanding the bandwidth that 911 could use, it is possible that the cell phones get a bit overloaded. If that happens, remember that 911 will continue to work. 911 works even when our cell phone grid is overloaded, but only use 911 for true emergencies. Being stuck in traffic, if you are okay, is not a true emergency.
Just a precaution, the whole disaster declaration to make sure our first responders and public safety officials are able to better manage traffic and crowds.
As the once-in-a-lifetime total eclipse looms over the city of Dallas, officials say it's all hands on deck.
Everybody that we have that is sworn personnel that wears a uniform at some point in time will be out working that day. As you said, the governor declared a state of emergency. We're not the only state that did that, but it's just in preparation for the literally hundreds of thousands of folks that we're anticipating coming into our state on Monday.
And small are preparing for the eclipse on Monday. And as of today, we've got our first East Texas county declaring a disaster for the weekend of the event.
The Arkansas Division of Emergency Management is still shooting high, telling me they are preparing for a surge of visitors. But whether it's a couple hundred thousand or more than a million, they want to remind everyone the total solar eclipse is a huge draw and historic event. We can see that sentiment here. The last time we checked in with Adam, the number of events planned throughout the state sat at 95. It's now 137, with the possibility of growing. Eric Eckhoff, the operations specialist with the Division of Emergency Management, says another thing that's changed are their coordination calls. They were holding those monthly, and that has turned into weekly calls involving local coordinators and emergency support function groups. As they prepare, they want Arkansans to do the same. Prepare to be on the road longer due to traffic. Have necessities on hand like water, snacks, and cash. Also, something you might not think of, cell service can be spotty.
In less than a week, Central Texas will be in the path of totality for the upcoming solar eclipse on April 8th.
We get a front row seat and the best view of this wonderful historic event.
What we've been seeing is an advanced case of what I call moon madness. In other words, lunacy. And there are two reasons at least for that lunacy. First of all, people are getting older and they have a bucket list. And on that bucket list, before they kick the bucket, is they want to see a total eclipse of the sun, to be part of the universe. And second of all, we have to realize that people want to be part of this larger tapestry called the universe.
Coming celestial occurrence could outdo them all.
Frankly, the solar eclipse is a big one.
All right, so here we go. Tens of thousands of people expected to visit the Metroplex next week to view the total solar eclipse.
Nothing with these on.
Right, because they're like welder's glasses.
Yes, I'm going to keep my...
I got to put my glasses on too here.
Well, you're not going to be able to see anything. I'm telling you that right now.
I'm going to guess here. So at about 10 to 1...
Yes.
Central time, we're going to have the moon start to do the eclipse here. And about an hour into it, you're going to get the full eclipse. And then it's going to pass on.
Okay.
So hopefully we didn't ruin it for everybody there.
No, hopefully we
we did it.
Excitement is building for Monday's solar eclipse, and as you probably know, you're not supposed to look directly at it without proper glasses. But buyer beware, there are some specs out there that don't protect your eye.
My eyes, the goggles do nothing.
All of these emergency declarations this time. What is going on?
What is going on with all the emergency declarations? Hello, friends. We are here on TSS with the Eclipse Watch, Eclipse Tricks, 4/7 on the Gregorian, April 7th. On the Gregorian 2024. Yes, partner Reno, how are things down there, my friend?
Things down here are bright, beautiful, blue skies across the board, balmy 88 degrees, feeling like 92. Got a lot of natural
60 degrees here, 60 but degrees. Sunny, sun, the sun, and it's been raining for 5 days here straight.
The sun after the rain never feels better, especially when it's been gray and miserable. And that is a time that it...
There's an eclipse that's about to, like...
Yeah. Is this the last day on Earth that we will get to enjoy sun, judging by the doom and gloom and doom...
Bring it on! Bring it on!
That have been circulating leading up to this eclipse have been beyond phenomenal. But welcome, regular offenders, one and all, new and old.
One and new alike. Hey, Andrea JT.
To the shit show.
Who's this guy?
Who's what?
No one watches RD. Who the fuck is that?
I don't know. He's just
Rebecca. Can you please ban him?
Ban me,
please. Like, he's got to go. He's just not acceptable.
People who are coming into the city.
RD is the best. That was a great intro. Fucking awesome intro, partner. You know.
Why? Thank you, sweet cheeks.
Hey, D Marquis. Hey, Lou. For right now, like Lou for right now on coke. You know, we already had this discussion. It reminds me of that Wu-Tang song. But anyway, partner, why don't you lead us to where we're going to be, what we're going to be discussing tonight in like the 2 hours or, you know, we'll see what happens. Like,
we see what happens with all of our best intentions.
It goes down, you got to be ready. You know who that is?
I can't say that I do.
Cypress Hill.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm not so familiar.
When the shit goes down, you better be ready. When the shit goes down. All right, everybody in the chat, yo, anybody subsequently watching that knows what I'm talking about, Cypress Hill, when the shit goes down, you better be ready. Please.
But thinking about it, we could have titled this A Fatal Eclipse of the Sun rather than A Total Eclipse.
Ooh, nice. Well, you said it, so...
Maybe, but there's always time to retitle tomorrow's Eclipse Watch. If shit goes down, we hope.
I like the title we have.
The Eclipse Tricks, I do.
That was mine. This one's yours.
But yeah, there we go.
We have in my power.
For tomorrow, but we are continuing our eyes on the eclipse. Narrative that is unfolding, and it actually unfolded on your channel about 3 or 4 weeks ago when I shared that screenshot with you of
I couldn't believe it. It was like 4 bullet points of things that I had never heard, like a township or a area, district, whatever, putting out top off your gas. Get all the grocery needs you need, do all this type of like basic shit before the 4th. And you did share that screenshot with me, and that's cray. That's fucking nuts. But obviously, like, if you're here and you don't know that, I mean, if I didn't have children, I'd be all right. You know what I mean? But I do kind of got to pay attention to those notices because... I need like extra shit when shit's shit.
Yeah, when there are more mouths to feed than more things are needed.
Yeah, and shit is shady. That's no doubt.
Shady, but from that screenshot, I mean, at the time we suggested it might just be a fancy meme designed to sort of scare people leading up to the.
I think fear. I always, you know me. I think everything is like multifaceted always. So I think fear is like totally.
Definitely. We are in rage of fear.
Conquer order out of chaos. Fear and confusion is how they accomplish those two credos that they constantly follow. If they broke, don't fix it. Look at the sun shining. Oh, I'm remembered of my cat captains when Camila Vasquez. The judge was like, oh, lower the curtain. She was like, it's okay, Your Honor. It's good light. Do you know what I'm talking about? The Johnny Depp Amber Heard show? All right. Maybe I'm crazy.
I'm familiar with all, or maybe if I saw it, I might be more reminded.
First cat I ever had my whole life, Captain Jack. I got him. I rescued him. He fit in my hand 3 days off mom's milk during that trial. So,
yeah, I remember that. That's where the origin of the name come from, Jack. But I'm not
first
familiar
cat
with
I ever had. This is the only kitten cat I've ever had in my life. Only ever had dogs. Sorry, partner.
Yeah, no, I've always actually when I was a kid, I had more cats than dogs, and then as an adult, I had more dogs than cats.
I kind of get that feeling. Yeah.
Now I've got one of each, actually three dogs and one cat.
Philia and three dogs, Dobby, Nugget, and Binny.
Yeah, they're all passed out, sleeping, siesta time.
That's what's up.
Three animals. But yeah, it's a little bit of a sort of...
I was like, siesta sleeping. Fiesta.
Yeah, it is around that sort of time of day that you'd kick back in your hammock, maybe have a sip of a margarita, a little puff of something, and sleep away for an hour or two until
dusk. What is something?
Whatever the something is that you enjoy smoking, be it cigarettes.
Cool.
Or, you know, some people like to smoke other things, but each to their own. But we're not here to talk about substances. We are here to talk about the sun and the eclipse. Although, actually, we do have a
sun is shining. The weather is sweet. Makes you want to move your dancing feet.
Would you like
60 degrees and sunny. Look, let me just share my screen with y'all. 60 degrees and sunny in the suburbs of Philadelphia. What's your temp down there in Mexico?
Currently 82.
Peninsula.
What? 82 degrees.
82. Oh my gosh, you're living it up. 60. It was pretty chilly and it's wet because, like I said, it's been raining for the past week.
Yeah, and they're actually talking about
Monday, last Sunday.
More rain and clouds due to descend over the eclipse path tomorrow. And they're saying that might force some of the people that have kind of located to the eclipse path, that some of these areas that are in line for bad weather. Some of the people are suggesting that now they're uprooting. Quick, let's get to a better location where we can see it. So it seems that more people, and earlier this morning I was talking to my friend in Indiana that said there's been even a larger influx overnight as a result of people trying to avoid the bad weather
to explore. And even just like traffic, because like through the path there's like Texas, there's Arkansas, there's all these places that are gonna be just, so they're telling locals stay home, but it's kind of like the same narrative, like I can't breathe, stay home. It's the same narrative, it's the same programming.
Together apart, you know, enjoy a distance
alone together is what the slogan was for Kovisha when she came to visit. What's good, Kelly Keeps? Andrea, it's nightly vlog.
Yeah, that irritated you the other day that my hat wasn't wonky. It was straight, although I'm sure there might be someone that gets irritated by my
bothered me.
No, it bothered Kelly that my hat was wonky the other day, but it actually does. It's wonky because it provides me shade from the sun. It's either that side or that side, depending on what of the day. But what exactly is going on with this eclipse? I don't think anyone truly can answer at this point in time. But the sort of starting out with a little screenshot with four or five eclipse tips conjured me to do a little bit of researching and looking beyond the screenshot to see if there was actually a story behind it, or if it was just a meme designed to scare and fear people into sharing it without knowing what it is they're sharing. And lo and behold, we've unraveled quite a startling amount of information and pre-preparedness, training, drills, FEMA involvement. I think currently at this point in time, don't quote me on this, but I believe, or have reason to believe, there's up to 60 counties that are currently under a
state. Well, we actually have proof to back it up, but we obviously, what my partner's saying is we can't prove it because we're not there. But if y'all are there when we read the jaunt, and you know, then get it on tape, let us know how many people are actually there, what actually is going on there. This is when we need boots on the ground.
Exactly. I don't think she's here at the moment, but I think we have appealed to Miss Blanche because she's in Arkansas. She's in
She's right, and it's so funny.
And she
the
was
name of the town she's near is Ma Elle. It's my name with M-A-U in front of it. Hay is for horses. Straws for cows. Milk is for babies won't shut their damn mouths.
All right, so I guess my partner is momentarily in this.
Sorry, I'm so sorry.
Okay. No, that's quite all right. Really, really...
Seven-year-old, you know, you gotta, I have to put him in his place. Like, he needs to know that that's a height of ignorance to interrupt. So, sorry.
Yeah, there was, what's that, Forever Flowers? I want to know the timeline of the U.S. I think it sort of hits the sort of...
I got it. Well, we're going to we'll look at it.
If it's around midday, I believe. But we will get into that. And since, I mean... The other sort of thing that we were hearing in the early sort of investigation to this story was people were suggesting that you had to have everything done before Thursday of last week. Don't leave it to chance. Don't risk it. Get everything you need, your medication, your food, your gas, your pets are sorted and situated. Have backup plans for communication in the eventuality of a, you know, cellular overload. If you don't know where there's a landline, find where the nearest one is. It sort of seemed an awful lot of panic regarding this. And then we went into this four-day period, which started on Friday, which many people sort of in the midst of this eclipse path are referring to it as the impact zone. And... you know, since Friday, I woke up Friday, and I'm sure some of you woke up on Friday, and my partner was disturbed while cleaning her teeth by the Eastern Board earthquake that hit New Jersey. And just hours before the New Jersey earthquake, there were earthquakes in Northern California, just north of Sacramento towards the Utah border area. One was 4.4, which took place on Thursday, the 4th of April, and the second one took place past midnight in the very early hours of Friday, the 5th of April, which was a 4.8 on the Richter scale. Then on the East Coast, where it's a little bit more rare to experience earthquakes, they also had a 4.8.
I'm so sorry. Do you know, is this directed to you? Because I don't understand that.
Is what directed to me?
The comment.
What comment?
On the screen.
I just thought it was funny and shows you just cause you're on a big platform, it's not all. I don't really actually understand what that is.
That's what I was saying. Is it just me or I don't even know what.
Unless is that sort of a comment above that is referring to?
No idea. But even if so, like what? Like this, I don't understand. 80 degrees in Kelly says, thanks for having your hat on, right? Rebecca says, please thumbs up. And yeah, we got the timeline for you, Forever Flowers. What's good, Rage? All right, we'll get into it. My partner's going to lead the show here.
Talking of the timeline.
Yeah, it was 4.8 in New Jersey was the epicenter. We felt it. I felt it.
And that's right. The eclipse is on 4.8. And something that cropped up in the omnibus edition to this was the Bengals Manic Monday. And I can't remember who it. There was a wish it was Sunday.
Wish it was Sunday. Yes. Which
obviously the solar eclipse.
I don't have to run today.
And the other funny thing about Manic Monday, wish it was Sunday, it came out in 1984. If or not, there's any significance in the Bengals.
Yeah, totally. Cindy Lauper and. Yeah, there's some definite shit. So let's do this, partner, because we said we were gonna do.
Yeah, that was the substance.
The cocaine. I like to talk about the cocaine. They're saying that United States Corporation, USA Today. Hold on. Let me put the Smith band for any newbies, which regular offenders and. Newbies, we hopefully will become a regular offender. Anyway, sorry, where was I?
The cocaine seizure.
Cocaine, that's right. 24, this is a lot of cocaine, okay? And we're not talking about like shitty ass meth or like trank dope. We're talking about cocaine, all right? Coast Guard seizes $24.3 million of the cocaine and Caribbean drug bust. Story by, it doesn't really even matter. That's a surname. This is what the U.S. Coast Guard. It says the U.S. Coast Guard seized a boat that was carrying 24.3 million dollars worth of cocaine on Friday. United States Coast Guard seized a boat that was carrying 24.3 million dollars worth of the cocaine on the Friday. The vessel with about 30 bales of the narcotics. 30 bales, guys. This is a big...
That's quite a party.
I mean, it's not even a party. It's an actual attempt to disable a population is how I see it. Drugs disable populations. And this would do it. I'm actually kind of shocked. I don't know whether to believe it. That's why I put the Smith on. Hold on. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me.
Yeah, so that was another sort of weird event while my partner is mom-lifing up that sort of took place on Friday. So we had earthquakes, enlarged drug busts, seizures made. I think somewhere there was a report that some money went missing, a large amount of money went missing.
Just like on 9/11, like
that. Yeah, you know, are we getting
like
ready?
That much, like it was. That
yeah,
much.
It was a sizable amount. It wasn't just a couple of bucks. It's all went in a local I can't say that word.
Constituency.
Thank you.
The vessel with about 30 bales of narcotics on it also had five alleged smugglers on board. Alleged, you know, everything here is alleged, guys. Channel labeled entertainment. No financial medical advice. RD doesn't offer that. We don't offer that here on this channel. It's labeled entertainment. fair use. You can use our stuff. Just don't change it around to make us sound gay. Unless it's funny, like South Park thingy.
That would be
anyways. Humorous. I'm sorry, what?
That would be quite humorous.
That would be great, right? The vessel with this 30 bales, the Margaret Norville, which is apparently the name of the boat, and boats are named after females typically. I love boats, not planes, but boats I do. And they typically are named after women. About 190 miles south of Puerto Rico, Baricua, Florida, Baricua. Anyways, members of the crew were deployed with two boarding officers from Coast Guard Tactical Law Enforcement Team South. What the fuck? That sounds like so compartmentalized and IDF trained to me. I'm just saying, like, off the top of my head, what it looked like. Here's a quote. Drug busts. Listen to this, RD. Drug busts like this one by Margaret Novell's crew save lives in reducing the flow of harmful narcotics to the U.S. corporation and disrupting the illicit maritime activity of transnational criminal organizations, end quote. Chief of Enforcement for the Coast Guard District 7. We're already in districts. So
don't realize
that, which I said this earlier in this stream. I say all the time. We're already, look, here, let me just drop this for you. Look at how they got the districts. Canada will be 0001. Okay. Canada will be known as America Area 0001. The former United States of America will be now known as 0002. Central America 0003, and so on and so on. And I'll give it to you. Please look at it. Give us your thoughts. We want to know what you guys
Yeah, I mean, that is a very interesting document, and by all means, look into it more. Now, in order to sort of get to districtization, if that is even a word, would it be a word? I don't know.
It is now, baby.
It is now. Will you create language here as well as provide?
They do it, and it doesn't make any sense. At least,
yeah, that's right. They do it. So what's good for the goose is good for the gander, as the old saying said, is. But they would need an event in order to rebrand into these districts, just like they needed an event to build a new project for a new American century. They needed a cataclysmic event in order to radically amend the American Constitution, something like a new Pearl Harbor. This is what it looks like now. They need an event in order to usher this.
Are they going to pull like a third, don't like a second half-assed Gulf of Tonkin shit? Because people are stupid enough to buy it. I wouldn't be shocked.
Tomorrow,
alternative avenues of thinking. I'm not saying that's happening. I'm thinking out loud.
And this is it. Are they about to false flag us in order to usher in the districtization of North America? And the reason that this sort of stands out about this, because in the intro, we heard somebody said, District 4 is ready and here's our celebration. And at the moment, under declarations of emergency or disaster being under
which there are many
more
be hard pressed to fight. We might as well report on what people, the states and shit that don't have, the municipalities and shit that don't have restrictions, because most of them do.
And maybe this is a divisionary tactic, but the other important issue to raise with emergency declarations and states of disaster is that emergency powers are now in enforcement, which means FEMA are in charge now.
Can I say something?
Go ahead.
If anybody has a yacht like that, or the shit, like, I'm down with all that. No, I'm just kidding. I meant the yacht, but I'm saying I'm down. Like, if anybody has a yacht, hit me up. Okay. I will totally.
I like how they've put the smugglers with the bags over their head, like the sort of beheading victims in those old school ISIS staged.
Oh my gosh, I didn't think of it like that. Just trying to party and bullshit.
And why didn't they just throw it in the sea? I mean, it would have dissolved. They could see the coast.
Nah, because they got it wrapped. It's wrapped in like saran wrap and Vaseline and so.
Yeah, I guess it would be a little bit, but I mean.
Yeah, it wouldn't break down and they would pick it up. But I would dump it because it's more chance of it you not getting charged with as much. Wow, look, they got sacks over these
33 or 5
says on the ground. February 8th, yeah. Oh wow. No, you don't say. 3,300 kilograms of drugs. What kind of drugs? Was seized from a Pakistani off the coast of Jakarta. So look, y'all, I wanted to report on this. My partner, we're going to get to more important things, but I thought this was noteworthy and I wanted to bring it to people's attention and just record it for posterity. So sorry, partner.
I've never really heard of cocaine busts in that part of the world.
I always cover the cocaine bus. Always. Always.
Sort of a more Gulf of Mexico type of
pastime.
But
what's good, girl?
But as I was just mentioning about this whole emergency, act of emergency, declaration of disaster, this is put into effect emergency laws and emergency powers that come with declaring an act of emergency, which means the Federal Emergency Management Agency or their local subsidiaries, in states and counties, have their own sort of localized branch of FEMA, which is just the Emergency Management Agency or whatever, Arkansas Emergency, Texas Emergency Management. They all have their little chapters and departments statewide and locally to do this. But the other thing with emergency powers and emergency acts is technically it's martial law.
Technically, they want us all dead eventually.
Technically, it is martial law. And
technically, they want us all dead eventually. That's a lyric from a...
I guess so. Probably from a
1990s rap. Does anybody know who that is? Hey, not Paul so from Newcastle. Nasir Jones, Nas. Nas is like half man, half amazing. So, partner, Reno, where shall we go?
Let's just start. You said you had the path of a totality and when it's going to start, the timeline. So why don't we show folks like that? But bear in mind, guys, a lot of these states now under states of emergency and disaster declarations now have emergency powers in effect, and they can utilize an awful lot of prerequisited field manual operation protocols to utilize things within their close proximity to aid with any situation. Now, a narrative that has been sort of delivered in a lot of the news reports that I featured in some of those streams over the last couple of weeks leading up to the eclipse have been talking about, and we'll be ready for the event, not we will be ready for the eclipse.
And they've even used the word impact.
They have used the word
very impact. Fucking crazy.
And the word totality is all, you know, the impact of totality and destruction, or maybe
totalitarianism. If you can look at the sun and you can look at the moon, dude, the guy laughed in the piece you put together, RD, so brilliantly you put together. The guy motherfucking laughed at the end of his speech. I can't believe I even have to say this. But where are these chintzy fucking NASA approved plastic fucking glasses? Like, you know, like it was so hilarious, but sick.
Yeah, quite a few of the sort of reporters I noticed.
I watched an eclipse. I'm 45. I've seen like six eclipses. I watched one when I was my youngest with glasses on. I think my parents thought it was protection. But after that, I looked at them with my eyes. The sun ain't 93 million miles away. Okay, it just ain't. And if you can look at the sun and the moon, that would be a pleasure to have some shit block the sun out for a second. It wouldn't be something you'd have to guard your eyes from. And by the way, I worked for an eye doctor for 3 years. So, yeah.
Yeah, neither. You know, the glasses is another interesting topic we've discussed. You know, could they be 3D glasses that they're giving out? Could they help make 3D holographic images look that much more lifelike and like they're popping out of the screen at you?
Or some tech we don't even know about yet.
Or some tech we don't even know about.
I say tech, but it'd be low tech, but like colors. You would be surprised. Most people don't even know that their dogs that they love and that's a man's best friend, they can't see color.
No, they see black and white.
They see black and white. They see red, but they see black, white, and black and white. And they can see red if it occurs. Yeah. So they can see black, white, and red dogs. But a lot of people don't even consider that when they think about. Anyway, point being, never underestimate anybody. We're all friends here, though. Thank you all for being here. We love
and
y'all.
They even look like the 3D glasses they used to hand out at the movies when you used to
They're
go and watch
so them. Chintzy. Like, what the fuck?
They probably just like relabeled 3D glasses and said they're Eclipse.
I'll wear my knockoff Pradas will protect me better than the fucking accent. But I do want to thank you know who you are for sending me a pair of Eclipse glasses. And when I went to my dad's and like fucking Christmas, he was like, I got my Eclipse glasses. I was like, oh, great. You know, him and his fourth wife, they got their Eclipse glasses, so they're safe.
Yeah, and does a comment I raised earlier in the stream, do the eclipse glasses only work as long as everybody wears eclipse glasses?
You can't take that off the table. That is a very real, or you could say it another way, and however many people wear them feed into the whatever the sick shit's going on that's going on, right?
I mean, yeah, it's.
So
I mean,
don't if, wear them, okay?
You know, if like, anything,
the fucking moon in front of the fucking sun, like what the? Come on, toughen up. I'm just kidding. I just feel like our society is so pussified, and calcified and fluorinated. It's just really aggro. Sorry, but go ahead.
Funny enough, somebody mentioned the selfies there. That was another thing that they put a safety advisory out. Don't take selfies.
I couldn't believe that when you showed me that.
There's been some very, very bizarre sort of
advisories
for this. Some of the more disturbing ones that I've heard is that blood banks are asking for donations. Why?
I've worked in a blood bank for 6 years, and that's rare. Blood banks, and it is because I saw the same thing you did. That is very rare and very disgusting.
Yeah, I mean that is something that usually only sort of happens after disaster, right? I mean, remember after 9/11,
and we had to turn people away after that September Tuesday because people were either. Or fine. There was no in between. So they were like, you're collecting too much blood. and I took cookies outside. It was very traumatic. I was like 21. It was bad. It was really bad.
Somebody mentioned there looking at the sun every. I look at the sun every morning.
The sun's like blind to me, but I love it. It's a good light, like Camille Vasquez said during the Captain Jack.
And sun is a wonderful medicine. I love.
Oh, I love it too. Yeah. You know I do.
Getting the natural dopamine, vitamin D, directly from the source, rather than in the shape of a Flintstones gummy. But let's have a look, if we can, at some of these. What was I sharing? Some of these disasters. Six counties in Texas have issued a disaster. That was from 2 days ago.
Hold up. Sorry. There you go.
All righty. So this is just, I just typed in the search bar at the top.
What's good, Betty R? It's good to see you. The perfect eclipse mask like the perfect friggin' mask that they were pushing. You guys, I have a video that I wanted to share. Maybe we could do it at the end if my partner reminds me. And it's Philly band masks. Philly band. Any kind of ski mask, any kind of mask, you can't wear them. It just happened this week. And like I said, I've been saying since Kovisha came to visit, Philly, you get the cops called at the very least. If not, you're shot dead for wearing a mask in Philly, in stores and shit. So, and now they've come out with an actual law. So I wanted to make mention of that, and I do have a proof, at least Smith Mont proof. Sorry, partner, go ahead.
Anyway, where was I? So yeah, this was just a little list of some of the counties that you can see there, 16 in central Texas. Where is this one here? That's also Texas. Let's switch over
Little Rock. Oh, I did get the map up.
Okay, we can check that out. Let me just, but there's so many. This is eclipse warning. Illinois have issued safety warnings. U.S.
The S is silent. It's Illinois.
Yeah, I have a speech impediment.
No, you don't. You're like way sexy and British. So you don't know that Illinois is the S is silent.
Well, maybe the accent
is. I was just telling you. Just so you know, that's all.
Well, thank you. My time in North America has taught me that the accent can titillate the female of the species. But look at all these warnings telling people to stock up in food, eyesight at risk.
Be afraid, be very afraid.
Warnings persist from ancient Maya today, and I'm actually in what was formerly the land of the Mayas, of Yucatan.
You are. Mexico.
We do have
other tribes went through there as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, the Incas, the Aztecs.
Yeah.
So a lot of ancient.
You are in a very rich land. So
spiritually,
I have a metal detector. So when I drive down there across the border, I'm bringing that thing down there. It's like brand new. It's in like a guitar case looking thing. I'm bringing it down there. And we're gonna go to the beach, through the jungle, and check it out. See what's up.
Well, you probably wouldn't find too much.
This starfish
in there, but this was a search for the eclipse state of emergency. If I switch tabs, Canada is declared.
There's so many of these. We got like, I literally have 10 fucking state of emergencies.
Yeah, New York. So pretty much anywhere it seems that is on the path and of the totality has declared states of emergency, which now are all technically under FEMA jurisdiction. So why don't you share the path and timeline of this, just to see where it is going to hit us and where people are going to be affected. But do be advised, guys, if you are in the path of totality and if you are in a city or town that is under a state of emergency or under a disaster declaration,
run!
Ron, you are currently under FEMA. You are under FEMA jurisdiction. So if anything does happen tomorrow, FEMA's in charge now.
FEMA's been in charge since Trump said NORTHCOM and SOUTHCOM are in charge when he declared a new war on drugs in his second year of his presidency. FEMA's been in charge. They're always in charge because that's the
government.
That's the boots on the ground. That's the boots on the ground. That's why I say we need boots on the ground. So what was I? What was I again?
The path in the timeline of the eclipse.
Hopefully
Miss Blanche will show up and she can provide us.
I should probably text her. I'm such.
That would be a good idea because it'd be nice if we could get her to sort of provide us a little glimpse of.
No, she said they're not picking up trash. She told me they're not picking up trash. They're not.
Banks are closed. Schools are closed.
Banks are closed. Yes.
Federal buildings are closed.
It's an eclipse. It's not a fucking, you know, avalanche. Like it really is concerning because I'm 45 and I've lived through eclipses, and you just
nothing like this.
And you look through them at school, and you know it's a thing, and that's it. This shit is new, and it's weaponized, in my opinion. This channel is labeled entertainment. It's Creative Commons. We are not monetized. No financial, medical, or any other advice is given here. This is just a comedy show.
Exactly, where we explore alternative avenues of possibility to titillate our humble few viewers that tune in.
That part, the regular viewers,
we love.
Is this it?
Is this what?
Can you see? No?
No, we're not. Are you sharing?
Yeah.
I'm not seeing anything.
Oh, I'm sorry, because you were sharing yours. I had.
Yeah, I just deactivated.
Go back. I'm so sorry. I'm sloppy with it when it comes to that.
When we first sort of come across some of these sort of bizarre in the early investigation to this sort of eclipse narrative, we're like, you know, are they Y2K-ing us? Are they sort of, you know, just blowing up a sort of event and hyping up the doom and gloom, doomsday prophecies? The other thing when people are...
I'm sorry. Partner, I just have to address, you know, I like to be interactive. I love all of the people that subscribe and give us watch time. Time is our most valuable commodity. Good show, RD, says Loki T. Daryl, very good to see you. But where's the NPC that still votes? Who are you referring to? Greg Fernandez? Look, guys, everybody serves a purpose. Some people can look at autopsies and detect issues with crime scenes. Some people can do, everybody, you chew up the meat and spit out the bones. The truth is the truth, no matter who says it. A broken clock is right twice a fucking day, and that's that. So I would like to know what you meant by that. But I'm sorry, I needed to address that, because where's the NPC that still votes? You know what I mean? My dad's an NPC. He votes, but his neighbor and best friend of 32 years ran the polls at the local high school, my local high school, the Yellow Jackets, black and yellow. Anyway, I would like to know what you mean by that. But anyway, go ahead, partner.
Good
to see you from across the pond. Butterfly, welcome in for a flash. Miss Blanche in the house. She can tell us about totality because it's going right over. It's actually named after me, Ma El, the town right outside of Little Rock where the eclipse will hit. They shut down to close the banks, they close the trash, and what else? You tell us, Miss Blanche.
yeah, let's hear some boots on the ground. But the first sort of, you know, thing I was saying, that when they advise you to stock up on food and, you know, medication, fill up your gas tank, all of this is consumerism.
You literally said make sure you get your prescriptions ahead of time.
Yeah, make sure you've got all the medication, not like, just you, what? Your animals and your pets and your children. Make sure you've got that on hand. If you go to see the eclipse, make sure you've got that on hand. You know, it's only a sort of 4 minute, obviously a bit of traffic.
Send me some money.
This is very, very beyond overkill and beyond any sort of Y2K threats and fear porn that we're given. Other disturbing developments throughout the last 4 days are that currently there are 70 military helicopters deployed across the United States delivering military grade equipment. I do have some stuff on that, but we were going to see the...
I can't do cocaine. And low-key to you late, we did about a cocaine bus. 24 point something million, was it? I think.
Yeah, quite sizable.
I have a heart condition, so I don't do that street drugs. Yeah, so hey, JB and Walter.
I mean, yeah, this is another sort of thing about getting people together. If you were staging an event that you sort of wanted a mass casualty to sort of sell the event, then ushering people into one location or into a, sort of a certain Maybe. Place, you would utilize your body count if they were.
I says same in Houston, Texas, and I know it's coming up through Texas before it hits Little Rock, MIL. That little town name that they made. Same in Houston, no school and no trash pickup. And yes, I saw that. D Nice, thank you for sharing that with us. That's some boots on the ground right there because she's there and she knows. Sorry, partner.
Yeah, did you want to get the map up of the path?
No, I have it. I have the map. My bad, man. Jeez, you guys are so harsh on a chick. Anyway, can you see this?
Yes, we can.
All right, so we're gonna go with this one right here. This one is okay. So Matt from Quantum of Conscience, whatever. QOC said that the 2017, which is the one you see going from the bottom right to the upper left in all these pictures, and the one that's coming, which you will see coming from the bottom left to the top right, will be the one that's coming April 8th. And it will come through Texas first. It will hit Little Rock. It will hit all up here. Now, it's going to cross 15 states, not to mention, pardon me, territories that are owned by the U.S. that are at sea that will probably see this. But we're going to go with this picture. So August 21st, 2017 is when this, because people here know this geography, and I suck with geography. But I mean, even I can understand, like, I live right here. This is Delaware right here. This is Florida. This is Texas. Like, you know what I mean? So hopefully everybody can see this. Total eclipse 2017 and 2024. I will go ahead and give you the link to this. Look, I just seen a story yesterday where, oh, they changed the path. Like, nobody knows what's going to happen, y'all. And if anybody comes to you and tells you they know what's going to happen in the sky, they're fucking lying. That's just my opinion, partner. Like,
I think we started out by saying we don't know what's happening. We're just gathering the information that that's available to us that maybe some people might be unaware of, and trying to make of it what we will. And there's a lot of money, a lot of overkill, a lot of emergency. And not only that, we're hearing how law enforcement in local sort of emergency agencies are all hands on deck. We need everybody, no vacation.
Absolutely, yes. They came out and did press conferences.
Yeah, there's been many, many strange press conferences. I think the most bizarre thing out of all of this I've heard was, I can't remember where it is. I think it's in Texas, but it's blue bonnet season.
Don't park your cars on the fucking grass or the blue bonnets.
Yeah.
And I get it. Like, I totally get it in Texas. Like, but it's almost like they know this is going to happen. Like, eclipses are nothing new, and that's important to recognize. However, eclipses are shady as fuck
by nature,
and they don't make sense. It don't make sense that the sun is 93 million miles away and the moon, like, it just doesn't add up in my mind. But I'm a crazy conspiracy theorist and an idiot. But here's another one. And the amount, like my partner said earlier in the stream, there is some 60 and up disaster declarations, like, you know what I mean? Like special implementations of like either relaxed rules where like everybody can carry gas, which I like that. But whatever, like, it goes the other way too, and it's bad, where you can't do that because of this eclipse and odd things, man, like top off your gas tank. Why?
For real. Well, like, obviously the consumerism, it puts a lot of money into the register.
Yeah, but is it short space of time? It can't be just that.
No, it's not that, but I mean, it does help a little bit. I mean, that was what they told you after 9/11. You want to help? Go and spend money. Go shopping.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a byproduct, but there's something else like deeper to this shit.
Deeper that. But just before I forget, you know, the blue bonnet. I said, why are they talking about blue bonnet until blue bonnet is double B, and another double B would be Bluebeam, Project Bluebeam.
And I left a comment under your video. I said blue bonnet, thinky face, question mark, and you wrote underneath of it what you just said.
Bluebeam, and we discussed, I think, in the first Eyes on the Eclipse live stream here on TSS, that we mentioned this would be a wonderful event for the production value alone of a real solar eclipse. And I've already heard somebody mention that maybe there was reports of a spaceship also following behind the asteroid, the devil.
Yeah, I've heard some extraterrestrials.
Heaven's Gate, the prophecy is coming true, which is another thing we mentioned. But this would be a wonderful staging ground for a holographic.
And alien. They use that word, guys. That's not my partner even using that word. Hey, yeah, they use staging area. Like, they literally use it in the piece that you show, partner. And all the videos are linked beneath, guys. Just go to the channel, look at them. No one watches RD, or nobody. What's it called? I'm sorry, hon.
Yeah, it is. Nobody watches RD.
Yeah, nobody watches RD. Or you can look up Reality Decoded. It will pop up like that. But yeah, it's good to see you, Rob. Static in the Attic did an interesting bit on the size of the shadow projecting on the earth and its size that makes you wonder. That, yeah, and that's where I'm at. Like, these things seem like fixed luminaries. Like, for real, when I look up at them, that makes more sense to me.
Yeah.
If I wasn't told anything in my life or scared to believe any type of way, that's what I would look up and see. But I recognize I've been indoctrinated and...
Well, the other similarities are, funny enough, there was a video that came out.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
We all going to die.
Yellow gold rooster, yellow gold award of the stream. First of all, sorry.
Research on Thursday night, I come across a video that said, can an eclipse cause an earthquake. And this video dropped hours before. It's in the stuff previously. If you want to go back, check it out there. But back in 1811, there was another total eclipse that took place in North America, almost identically on
the of the heart.
A total eclipse of the heart. But it took place on almost an identical path. And at the time, there was Napoleonic conflicts going on in Europe with, skirmishes on the Russian border. And after the eclipse, it triggered, although they don't say the eclipse did it, but in the aftermath of the eclipse, it triggered a series of earthquakes that ravaged the northeastern border of North America for several months. And they got more and more devastating each and every time.
Partner.
And the synchronicities of that occasion were also a comet was visible in the sky.
And we have the devil's comet. It's actually called something else, you know, of course, scientifically. Hashtag science bomb. Which one is it, partner? Is it Eyes on the Eclipse?
Yeah, I mean, that's like 7 hours long, so I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. But what was the one you were just talking about? Because I saw it, and I didn't watch 7 hours of it.
I'll
tell you that right now.
I'm not sure which it would be, and no one watches RD stream.
Okay.
It was very interesting. It's like sort of slightly animated presentation of all these things.
All right, well, make sure you guys go here and check these out, because I did watch one of these, and I plan on watching the other one. I can't believe there's only 200. This is so lame. This is how you know you're telling the truth.
But everything up until this live stream related to the eclipse from Ship Video Productions is contained in that omnibus edition, and it kind of serves a dual purpose as chronologically documenting from start the screenshot. This is strange to states of emergency and declarations being of disaster being declared, blood banks offering for donation, military helicopters flying overhead, earthquakes breaking out. It's been a strange ride. And even if nothing major does happen tomorrow, this has been a psychological operation in itself, with all of this hype and preparedness and advisories and safety tips.
You are so right. You just put into words what I don't think I could have. And that is why I say people are in a constant state of fight or flight. And when you are in that state, there are certain things that your body, your natural physiological, actual like functions of your body, your brain, all this cannot do when you're in fight or flight. So this is why fear, confusion, order out of chaos, division, all these things are such a useful and long used tool of every oppressor, which governments are. Govern means to control, meant from the Latin mente, mind control. They need to quell the public. They need to keep you docile, right? Right. So sorry, just wanted to add
very
that.
I'm glad you did. This is it. Nobody up until this point, other than those that are involved or maybe have agendas and plans for tomorrow, we don't know. They would be the only ones that know what's going to happen.
I wonder if P. Diddy has plans for tomorrow.
Maybe he is. Maybe here come.
Big motherfucker.
He'll write in on the comment with Jesus and an alien.
Hey. Devil's comment, guys. April 8th, tomorrow. LHC, Large Hadron Collider at CERN being fired up. And April 8th to the 10th is when Aleister Crowley kind of christened his book, but the opposite of crescent, whatever the fuck that is. I don't even know what they call that because I wouldn't know what they would call such a thing. I'm sorry. Yeah, and they totally, like, Kells, good comment, great comment. Because they totally, like, sell it. They're totally selling it. Like, the glasses have to be NASA approved and whatever, but they're making so much money off of it in these towns. Miss Blanche will tell you. But they're also shutting shit down because they don't want traffic. So they're like, oh, we don't want motherfuckers going to work because we have people coming in here into this. Did I put the map up?
Yeah, we saw the map. Yeah, like all federal and government buildings are closed.
No, like, but when has that ever happened? Do you remember that? Like,
no, I closed.
I'll admit that I may not even know. I may not remember. I don't know. If you told me that they've always been closed, I would believe you. I really couldn't tell you.
I mean, it'd be interesting to see if there are any sort of big corporations that are operating within the totality zone, what they're calling the
Empire. I fucking doubt it. It's probably like Larry Silverstein and his...
We don't know. Sometimes sort of...
Son and daughter, they all just
want to buy and develop on, right? My hometown in England was a piss-pot insignificant city, but its location in proximity to London and the price of the land there saw Motorola, Intel, Castrol. We had the major Honda factory in operations, and they all put up operations there because it
platinum. Was Rooster got the platinum. Sorry, go ahead.
But I was going to suggest that if there are any sort of major organizations or companies that have operations in the flight path, it would be interesting to see if they put options on their stock. Now, some of you guys would have heard of put options from 9/11, but last year during what was I call the Go Woke or Go Broke campaign, there were lots of companies, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, lots of them across the board, all put sort of gender neutral.
You're not gonna knock out Coca-Cola and Pepsi, but yes, there were
many
companies that went woke.
They went broke. But they didn't go broke because Coca-Cola
and Pepsi didn't because it's
no, they didn't because they put options on their stock before they launched the ad campaign. This is information that I have shared on Twitter. Coca-Cola, Anheuser-Busch, Costa Coffee, all the companies that are owned by, you know, Coca-Cola had lots of companies under its umbrella. Costa Coffee were one.
Dasani water is Coca-Cola.
Yeah, exactly.
They I don't buy that water for that reason. I don't drink soda.
But they all put options on their stock prior to their Go Woke, Go Broke advertising campaign. So maybe they lost on...
I wish it was like really woke, like just don't drink soda at all. Like... Anyways, sorry.
But we know that United Airlines and I think American Airlines had placed put options on their stock prior to the events of September
11th. Yes. And
usually this is sort of
Donald Rumsfeld came out and said that we were missing whatever, how many of our trillion dollars. Yes, they came out about the put options. But it was within like a 4-hour stretch, and then the shit went down. Again, Cypress Hill. You don't know what I'm talking about?
I know Cypress Hill, but I never like paid attention.
You better be ready when the shit goes down. I'll send it to you. BlackRock gets all the votes. I can't read that out loud, but I won't take that off the table, Lou, for right now. So where do you want me to go next, partner?
Well, I was going to say, as we've mentioned, the military helicopters, why don't we go and look at that?
Yes.
That is very relevant because I can refresh it, but 5 hours ago when I did the search, I don't know if you can see the screen yet, but the first is from Philadelphia, 6 ABC Philadelphia. Army helicopters are seen flying through the area as they move military equipment. 22 hours. Guys,
Philly is so dense. When they say they're flying, that also means they're felt. They are felt. Sorry, my resident.
Swinner? Is that how would you pronounce that? Is that in Philadelphia?
What? I can't see that shit.
Susquehanna? Susquehanna?
Susquehanna, yeah.
That's in your name.
Yeah.
So there's why and what when some 70 military helicopters will be flying in and out of Lehigh Valley. The public should not be concerned
Lehigh
with
Lehigh Valley. Lehigh?
Yeah, Lehigh Valley.
Yeah. I'm not too far from here.
Army helicopters refuel at Allentown Airport on Saturday, and there are photos. Should we click on that? Allentown. The morning call. And here it is. Look, Saturday, this was from yesterday. There's a picture. Look at those helicopters.
I would have swore, I would have told Jesus if he was in front of me. Yes, Lord, there was three low-flying military helicopters. If I had to guess, Chinooks or maybe Apaches. But no, it was a fucking earthquake. We don't get those here. Now, I've felt two before in my whole life in 45 years, but that's it. Like, this ain't Cali. Like, we don't get earthquakes here. It was crazy. It was nuts. I will say it was crazy.
No, we're not supporting quality news. Go away, stupid pop-up. But yeah, look, there are the helicopters landing. 3-3 in the middle there, although 1-3-1-3-1, but mirror image as above, as below. How does that saying go?
As above, so below.
There you go. That was what I was thinking of.
I love Felicia Lockhart. And rest in peace to, well, I don't want to say Benita. Rest in peace, Benita.
But the list goes on.
That lies with a voice. Rest in peace. Sorry. Go ahead.
But most of these seem to be coming from Philadelphia. But when you said that you would have sworn that they were helicopters, maybe that is what you...
I ran to the door. Me and my seven-year-old, it said that it hit here, right? The epicenter was in North Jersey, which I'm in the suburbs of Philly. Like
I could okay.
I'm right next to the airport.
And is Lehigh Valley International close to you?
It would be north, mostly north, but a TT west of me. Lehigh Valley wouldn't take me long. Maybe it would take me like 40 minutes. It is a different county.
Right. So it's close enough to you because 3 days ago, military exercises are being staged at that airport. So maybe you did feel helicopters, and it does even say here.
I'm not, thank you for saying that. Thank you for saying that because I'd like to think with my daddy being a Vietnam vet and me sitting on his knee looking through a telescope and he'd be like, it's your Uncle Willie if it was like a biplane. And I've never been on a commercial flight, but like if I've heard biplanes, he's been like, that's Uncle Willie. But anyways, thank you for saying that because I do have an ear for it.
They're very distinct.
Delaware near the Dover Air Force Base where they bring all our boys home, dead and alive, but all the dead come through Dover, Delaware. Okay. Funny, Dover and Delaware are both places in the UK. I'm sure, partner, you can.
Yeah, they are. There's a lot of
Rooster. We are going to stream tomorrow. Me and RD together. We're going to do an eclipse. What eclipse tricks?
I'm going to break into some recovery then. I was going to break into a little bit of Lee Rick Astley then, but let me get back to this, because this is very interesting, guys, because drills go live and another 9/11.
Whoa, pause. What Rick Astley?
Together forever and never to part.
So you were going to really Rick roll? Like, how old are you?
Well, you said we will be streaming tomorrow together, and then I was going
to
break
well,
in.
Well, I was responding to a comment. I was actually answering a question.
Yeah, and I was going to accentuate to that comment by Rick rolling you with the lyrics to Together Forever.
Isn't that like feeding into meme control, though? Like, if you were to, like...
I'm a child of the 80s, and I remember Rick Astley before
me
he was...
Me too. Teen. Fuck, so do I. 1978. My name's L. 1978. Rick
Astley. I wonder why my computer is taking a shit on there. Look, that's very strange. The page is unresponsive. You can
that
wait.
Looks like the Gothard Tunnel opening. What the hell? But nah, friends.
Are you seeing this? Look, my page is unresponsive, and I'm trying to expose or not expose, but show the fact that there is a military.
Yeah, don't use words like that. That's probably not good for
us. Scheduled for Allentown Airport this weekend. So there's a military exercise going on. On 9/11, there was a military exercise going on that sent all the planes out to the northwest.
They scrambled them incorrectly, the FAA, and it's worse than that. If you look up the FAA, the Federal Aviation Agency, on that September Tuesday, you will see all kinds of deficiencies and inconsistencies and flat out fucking just lies. And it's still up. You can find it on the interwebs. Get it while you can. Don't take my word for it. You can still find it. Sorry, partner. Go ahead.
Well, anyway, as I'm trying to express that we have a military grade exercise going on, as well as declarations
of emergency. Girls gone live, like my
yes.
partner.
And that was what a comment from that. Why? I just copied that, didn't I?
I don't know, but I'm going to play this in the background. Hold on, let me turn it down.
But this is very strange, because this web page is suddenly become unresponsive. And this is interesting to me, because none of my other pages are seemingly at the moment are being unresponsive. It may be
this
they
looks
don't.
Very much like a Gothard Tunnel. I mean, I'm just saying, like, that's what the fuck that looks like.
Well, this is the military exercise that's taking place at the airport by you that includes Apache, Chinook, and Black Hawk helicopters. And you said that you thought you felt the sound of Chinooks. And just a few more minutes away, a 40-minute drive, as you said, at this Lee Allen County International Airport, there is currently a U.S. military exercise going on, and the web page won't let me continue by reading. Let me see if it's responsive now. And no, it isn't. Should we come out and see if we can go back?
You're not American.
But why don't you, if you can click on the link in the chat, you can possibly see if you have any.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Because this is very interesting.
Hold on one second.
But military drills, emergency declarations, a disaster, state of disasters. This is all lining up to look as though something is going to go on. And, you know, we try not to fear porn you. I can't say what is going on, but there's a military presence, and when they're telling you, don't worry, nothing to see, it's just an exercise. That's why we're moving military-grade equipment around in the skies. Moving military-grade equipment around might suggest that they're positioning or deploying, ready and waiting for something to invade. If or not anyone is trying to see what I'm saying there, but are they using the exercise as the cover screen to put things into place that might be needed tomorrow for the event that we keep hearing about. And
I got some stuff. Do you want to see it?
Yeah, why not?
Sorry. Did you want to see the stuff?
Yeah, let's have a look. Let me stop sharing the screen. But there's a lot of information, guys, if you want to go check it out for yourself. Military helicopters, 70 of them are currently being deployed and are partaking in military exercises where they are transporting.
Oh my gosh. There's dogs barking outside of my door right now, like frantically.
Are they reacting to something, do you think? Can you hear other dogs in the background? I wonder if there are any videos. Oh, that's from 4 weeks ago. No, let's see what's in the news. Although I've stopped sharing my screen. Army helicopters have been seen through the area as they move military equipment.
See, I didn't see these. I just, from my daddy and just growing up and knowing, going to air shows and knowing the sounds, I did not see them, but I would swear they were Chinooks, three of them. I would swear that they were three low-flying military helicopters, and I would guess Chinooks, like the double rotors.
Yeah, they have a very distinct
Or possibly.
In Simitu, I grew up close to some RAF bases and a United States Air Force base in my hometown, and we often seen all sorts of helicopters and aircraft flying overhead. The space shuttle landed close to me once when it was carried on the back of the 747 because the airbase had the longest runway in England, so it was needed to land, and we all got the day off school to go and watch it through the fence. It's quite exciting as a 10-year-old. But I don't know if it is cause to be disturbed that military are carrying out military exercises, and
I think it's cause for concern.
As the earthquake was in relative close proximity to you, as the military exercises also in close proximity.
Listen, this shit caused a New York City apartment to spew water. Like, I hate to be like raunchy, but it really does look kind of phallic, like jizz on a, like I'm saying, this thing, of course. And fuck you, Kathy Hochul. Yes, infrastructure will be. You can't send. You already put 100,000 people in the subway, and there was a shooting 2 days later, and people died. Like, there's nothing they could do, y'all. Don't wait for somebody to save you. Train yourself. Get ready yourself and protect your family, because that's what you need to do.
And that is another interesting factor to bring into this equation, that military are also deployed on the streets of New York, where they've just experienced an earthquake, where a military-grade exercise is just going on and taking place over the weekend of an eclipse. You'd think if they were going to conduct an exercise, they could have picked any other weekend.
Well, actually, it's not an exercise. They put the 100,000...
The helicopters are part of an exercise, right, not the military on the street.
100,000 fucking men from the reserves is a lot of men.
Exactly.
And they put them all in the subways all across New York. And 2 days after this Kathy Hochul from where Tops Market banger happens, in Buffalo, Massachusetts, listen, I don't know what to say. I just, if you look at the reporting on it and whatever, it seems like she may, I can't believe other people aren't seeing this, but that she, how could she not know? Like, I just can't get past that. Like, how would you not know that? You know what I mean? Like, I don't know. Maybe it's just me.
Yeah, I must forgive me. You've lost me a little bit. Who are we talking about?
Mitchell. She took over for Cuomo in New York. And she's talking about the disaster, like the earthquake. Uh-huh. The epicenter was in Jersey.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Lebanon, actually.
Yeah, and this is where they installed the 100,000 National Guards in these New York subway system, which goes through Staten Island, which I don't know if you saw my stream earlier, but we showed the Statue of Liberty shaking from the earthquake. And I mean, that's scary. I mean,
it also got struck by lightning. But yeah, so let's just break it down. We've got 100,000 military trained personnel situated in the region, that a current military exercise is going on, including 70 military grade aircraft, which would be able to provide air support for a ground force that are also distributing military grade weapons and equipment that can be deployed to those 100,000 troops that are deployed in and around New York City. Now, in 1811, the eclipse come by, and then the series of earthquakes begun. We've already had the series of earthquakes.
Well, I don't want to skip past that. In fact, I'm gonna pull that up, because in 1811, like, I don't want to. That's a good piece of knowledge that you have there, and a lot of people don't know that. But that is a fact. So if you could say that again, and I'll pull up proof of it.
Yeah, the synchronicities of the 18. I mean, it is documented. I do have a piece on this.
Grab it. Just say it again.
But yeah, in 1811, there was a total eclipse of the sun that took place in North America. And the events that superseded that eclipse began with a series of earthquakes. It got rapidly bigger each and every time there was one, until there was a very, very devastating one that called the banks of the rivers to sort of slide in construction and building. Back in 1911, things weren't as developed as they were now, and the other sort of mass casualties of that earthquake were the indigenous people, because they were, you know, in 1811 there weren't so many settlers in as there were now, and there was still a larger.
I think 1811, they would still be like doing pretty good. But
well, the indigenous people.
Did you say 1811 after eclipse?
No, 1811. Total eclipse, 1811.
I put 1811 and DuckDuckGo. 1811 after eclipse earthquake. Is that
eclipses and earthquakes?
Because if they you come up. Here, let me show you my screen.
Go ahead.
This is how they do it. This is how they do it. When you look it up, it's so sick. It ain't even right, actually. It's a lie. It's deceitful. It's not what I asked for. So I put in here 1811 after eclipse earthquake, right? Because that's what we were talking about, right? Uh-huh. So we get 5 hours ago from Catholic News, 3 days ago from the Tennessean, New York Slimes, 2 days ago. So this is the problem, the whole problem, in my opinion, that everyone is getting their information from the same place when people should really just unfucking plug. And that's really dumb for me to say, because me and my partner we're not monetized. You know what I mean? We don't really make money off this, except for, you know, like kind people that donate a couple bucks here and there. But point being, what was I saying? Pam, hold up. I gotta get my boys some Brita water, no tap water. Sorry about that. Anyways, I wanted to just say that.
Would you like to pull the screen up?
Oh, sorry. Thank you. You can't see it?
No, not at the moment.
Really? Wow, that's crazy. Sorry about you. Why is that not, why is that not doing that? You don't have any kind of like blocks on me or anything like that, do you?
Any what now?
Got it. Never mind. All right, Ham. My goodness. Anyways, what would you like me to click on, partner? You know.
I don't know. Check your
pick. Vortex. I'm sorry.
Take your pick.
Well, the New Madrid earthquake chaos. I mean, should we just go with Smithsonian Mag? That's just like the first journal that came up.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, let's do that because that's what they want us to see. This shit is so regulated, y'all. Like they want us to be looking at this. That's not lost on me or my partner. So, just so you know that. Ham, go lay down. The great... Sorry. The Great Midwest Earthquake of 1811. Very interesting numbers.
You added the one and the eight together.
My goodness. Triple ones. 200 years ago, a series of powerful temblors devastated what is now the Missouri. Could it happen again? December 2011. This is by,
it's a nice picture.
Yeah, I like it.
I mean, tragic, but it's a nice picture.
I think I
could. You probably didn't have many cameras in 1811, so they had to sort of paint pictures of the disaster.
I think you could do it better. Like, shit. I always thought I was born too late, especially if I was born in 1811. I could have done it better. But anyways, 2 days before my dad's birthday, in 1811, residents of the frontier town of New Madrid, which is now Missouri, was jolted from their beds by a violent earthquake. The ground heaved and pitched, hurling furniture, snapping trees, and destroying barns and homesteads. Yeah, like back in the day when that shit was like how you lived, which is what it should still be like. Good boy, lay down, lay down. The shaking rang church bells in Charleston, South Carolina. And toppled chimneys as far as Cincinnati, Ohio. Quote, the screams of the frightened inhabitants running to and fro, not knowing where to go or what to do, the cries of a thousand beasts of every species. I feel like I'm reading like a spell or some shit. The cracking of trees falling formed a scene of truly horrible, whatever, said what resident. Look, obviously, the shit was not good. All right.
Yeah, it caused a lot of damage in quite a large death toll. So you also didn't have sort of medical facilities and sort of first responders like we sort of have now. And it wasn't necessarily the earthquake, but it was all the diseases and the dirty water and all that sort of shit that come along afterwards that wiped a lot of people out. When I heard of the earthquake and I did a little bit of research on Friday morning, I come across a video about that that was dropped on Thursday night, hours before there was knowledge of any earthquakes. Since then, not only were there the earthquakes in New Jersey and out on the West Coast in Northern California, there were also five smaller earthquakes, boom, 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 in a line on the Madrid fault line that also took place during...
Yeah, the New Madrid, and that it's our turn to get it. And that's when I say that about the U.S., that's part of what I mean. Because seismic plates have not been fucked with in a while, and it's our turn to get it.
And they are saying that it should be due within the next, before 2040, that area should be due a big one. History sometimes rhymes if it doesn't repeat. And many of the events now, there was also the comet in Thatcher, there was an eclipse, and then a series of earthquakes. We've got a comet.
We have the LHC getting turned on too, April 8th.
Exactly.
Like,
the
solar eclipse safety warnings issued in one state. People are putting the hammer down. They're like, you can't go out of your house. You can't do this. You can't do that. You better get your gas. You better da da da. in the path. You know, hold on. Let me get back to the path. Hold on.
While you're doing that, let me just remind the viewers, last year, FEMA conducted a multi-state natural disaster mass casualty scenario.
Let me say the name.
Do it.
Frosty Force.
Frosty Force, folks. Double F. Last year, FEMA conducted a double F exercise for a mass casualty multi-state natural disaster scenario. Military have been deployed, military exercises are going on, and state of emergencies have been declared. FEMA are already on power, are in power in some of those places that have declared emergencies or disasters. If it's not FEMA themselves, it will be one of their subsidiary emergency manager agencies that have been localized on their behalf and if they need further assistance. Now, the other thing that may not be as sinister as a reason that there are so many counties because of the funding that they will be entitled to should a disaster break out in there, sort of pushing the, it's just for the traffic congestion. And maybe people might get a little bit excited and overcrowded and overwhelmed by the incident. And that might well be why they've done this, but they can then declare a disaster if maybe a fence falls over or a police car gets damaged. It was a disaster, and then they can receive funding from the government. It might be
just and not over. Only that, there are things like that and loopholes and shit like that a million times over. Okay, not a million, but thousands, I bet.
Yeah, so
if
sure,
not
maybe
like almost 1,000 times over. That shit gets suspended. Just look at PACON 1991. Like, they suspend shit for emergencies, declarations of disaster, all of this. We know this. Everybody here knows this. If you don't know it, now you do. If you don't believe it, we could see it through. But this is a fact. It's not a theory.
No, it's not. And all of this information we're giving you sort of regarded military helicopters in advanced planning and preparedness for this event is all factual. We've taken a lot of it from government websites. We've seen there that there is a military exercise going on. We know that there's military personnel deployed in New York City. We know New York City has been the target of false flag events in the past. We know that FEMA were involved with those false flag events in the past. We know that there were military exercises going on during that false flag event in the past. Are we on the eve of another one, folks? And something that disturbed me, I have mentioned this maybe one or two times before, the most about 9/11, that on 9/10, a group of individuals went to bed that night knowing exactly what they were going to execute the next day while the rest of us were unbeknownst. And right now, if something is going to happen now, there is a group of individuals on this planet in a secret bunker or an office or an airplane or a boat.
That know exactly what's going to
happen. And all the things we're telling you and show, we're not here to fear you. We are exploring emergency alternative avenues of possibility, but
emergency shit's getting real in the field, right? That's what they say here in like Philly on the radio stations and stuff.
And
it's getting real in the field, right?
It seems like it's getting real. There also was another earthquake yesterday in San Francisco. I think it was only 3.9. But did I give the link to the military?
Don't give San Francisco my earthquake clout.
No, I'm not going to give San Francisco anything. It's not a nice city.
No, this fault lines, cray, guys, and this, like, I know California, but they're like, they built because they know they have earthquakes. Cali did, and they. You know what I mean? The East Coast did not build like that. Not for earthquakes.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, a lot of structures in Southern California are sort of designed to withstand sort of a certain level of earthquake. I mean, the big destructive ones, nothing really sort of stands in the way. But on the same token, we were told that those solid steel twin towers were built to and designed to withstand an aircraft impact. Who would have known that aluminum planes would have been able to...
Well, I believe they were. I believe the engineer did... He died, you know, on 9/11. The person who... engineer of the building did die like the 37th floor or some shit, I don't know, but he did die. So it's like a captain going down with the ship kind of. Yeah, you can look it up. Hey, off grid ping, good to see you. The church blowed up last October. Saint, I can't even say that, Greek Orthodox Church. Yeah, I don't know that. I suggest everyone read Fox's Book of Martyrs ASAP. I don't even know what that is. Hey, Rage, why do you look different? You look different. Why do you look different? Sorry, partner.
Changed his profile. But is that the impact site there?
Nice. This is just the Smithsonian.
Oh, right. That's sort of showing you the sort of red, amber, or green zones.
No, this is the earth, what you just taught me about, the earthquake of 1811.
Okay.
But the path of totality of the eclipse follows the path of this fucking earthquake, which is why it, you know, I'm bringing it up, why I was impressed and thought it should be, because this is the path right here, right through the New Madrid fault line, right through it. And I showed it to you and I'll show it to you again. You know what I mean? Right there. You could see, right? So that's why I brought it up.
Yeah, they lined it up. And you sort of see that that is an area that on the hazard sort of scale, it was mostly green, whereas sort of the west coast was prominently red and yellow. So it is rare to get earthquakes there. And in the last week, they've had a whole bunch of earthquakes there. Those five smaller ones didn't make the headlines as much as obviously sort of the events in New York and New Jersey, because of bigger cities, especially New York. But the paths are identical, but I guess that's sort of to do with the solar system, that, you know, the paths every now and then, you know, like Halley's Comet comes every 76 years, so sort of every now and then the sort of paths will overlap, I guess. But is history about to repeat? One can only speculate at the moment, but there's enough going on, unusual goings on right now. It's certainly in North America and in Canada as well. The Ontario, which borders, Southern Ontario borders New York State. That is also under a declaration of disaster preemptively to the eclipse, and you know, it's in sort of close proximity to where this military exercise is going on, where military personnel are deployed, where they've already had an earthquake. We already have an event coming tomorrow which is going to have a very, very large audience. All sort of guys are going to be on that. So any sort of clandestine operations that are going on at a ground level may go unnoticed, and this is why we might be seeing these military helicopters moving military equipment around under the guise of a military exercise, because they need to be put in place for something that's coming. And I can only speculate, if you're putting military grade equipment into you know, battlefield or deployment situations, then it can only be for something that's coming here that isn't very pleasant, that could almost support the alien arrival event tomorrow under the shade of the eclipse. And sort of TSS in its genesis spark, we did our very, very first stream about the Chinese weather, not weather balloon, spy balloon, and the East Palestine train derailment, which are objects in the sky and a train derailment are the sort of first act of close encounters of the third kind, that then needed a very large area to be evacuated under the guise of a toxic chemical leak from the train in order to pull the mothership into us. But another movie that depicts an alien arrival that sort of started friendly but went tits up very, very quickly was Mars Attacks. And in Mars Attacks, they located everybody there ready and waiting for the arrival event, including the military. If you can remember that movie, they arrived in Las Vegas and the military were there.
Mars Attacks, yeah.
It's a very goofy, stupid movie, but...
Not really. It's pretty classic. It's like a cult classic, like Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Yeah.
Like Rocky Horror Picture Show, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, it's got a good death count in it, and got quite a few big name actors in it. Yeah. But the other thing in that movie was sort of events that were leading sort of up to the invasion. And last year we also reported on cattle mutilations, as well as those strange alien events, the Vegas alien encounter where the guy saw a 10-foot creature taking a dump in his backyard that sort of shut down or blew up the internet for a few days. Not long after that, we had that strange mall event.
Aliens be able to figure out how to not do a number two? Because
maybe, we don't know.
Females are better than men, like smarter, like a little bit ahead. So wouldn't they like figure out a way to like potty better? I don't know. Just
yeah, thought. They might have a much, much better way of going to the bathroom than we do. But you know, I as a sort of UFO
I don't, you know, I don't poo. I'm like Kim Jong-un. Don't poo. Never have in my whole life. No one's ever seen me do it. So prove it.
Well, thank you for that information, and viewers. If you want to prove my partner wrong, knock yourself out. Go to town.
What kind of partner are you trying to get them to Spy on me.
I'll pay big bucks for an Al Puin pick.
Never gonna happen. Never gonna happen.
Yeah, interesting goings on, folks. But, you know, as a sort of UFO and an alien, I mean, it was those sort of things that kind of drew me into researching mysteries and conspiracies many, many, many years ago as a young child. And I've sort of been waiting for the alien event to happen for some time, so I'm sort of secretly excited. But the alien narrative has been already.
Like, let's go.
Get it over with. But the alien narrative has unfolded under the sort of distraction of COVID and lockdowns and pandemics, and sort of in the first year of the pandemic, UFO sightings went through the roof. Within the second year of the pandemic, we had videos.
Hold on one second. I'm sorry, I have to mute.
Am I okay to continue? Okay. So we've had pretty much in the last 4 years soft launches. The media have been referring to it with the regards to the alien. We've had a whistleblower come through. Is it Stephen Goresh or David Goresh? It sounds very much like David Goresh.
David Goresh and Stephen Greer.
Stephen Greer. These are the two players.
Fuckers. But
Congress have admitted what they're saying is true.
Like some little itty bitty truth with fake actors or, you know, these types of people, and it just doesn't work. But yes, David Grush and Stephen Green or some shit. I don't fucking know.
But the seeds have been well and truly planted for that narrative and that agenda. And all we're waiting for is for the seeds to bloom into action. And, you know, what better occasion to stage an alien event than under the shadows of an eclipse. And let's not let's take this opportunity to remind our viewers of our infamous stream that was community struck while the stream was still running, cloud cover and smoke screens. Now, last year, my partner and I also did a stream called Solar Saturday, where we reported on lots of solar activity, solar flares, radiation coming off of the sun that were reportedly going to affect the Earth one way or another and could even possibly cause a grid down situation. A power surge similar to an EMP. In the week after, we did the cloud cover and smokescreen stream, suggesting that why are they covering up the skies? Why is there so much thing burning that are causing smoke clouds? Why are there so many cloudy skies and hurricanes that are blocking out the sun? That maybe, just maybe, they needed to sort of be up there setting a few things in place up and ready to go for when it happens. And is it going to happen tomorrow? With all that is at play at the moment that we've shown you and documented from a fucking screenshot of eclipse tips, we've now, the day before, discovered that there is a very large military exercise going on in very close proximity to where the earthquake took place. It is also in the path of totality. Your mic's not off if you're trying to speak. I can see the lips moving then. But not only that, we keep repeating it. You've heard it on the mainstream news. States of emergency, disasters have been declared. Emergency powers are in effect. FEMA is currently in charge of all of those cities, towns, and counties that are under emergency powers tonight until Tuesday. Some of them don't relinquish powers till Thursday. Now, emergency powers, sometimes once issued, are very, very hard to give back. Unfortunately, my channel RD, no one watches RD, is under community strike at the moment for a video I put up about the three body problem, which also come out very conveniently in time for the eclipse is coming out. It sort of does involve suns and alien invasions and impending doom. if or not that is in conjunction or coincidental, just accident, that timing and release was prior to something that could well be very similar to the script of that TV series taking place in real time, real life. So I've got a little bit off track of myself there. But events are unfolding. Many things seem to be in place. We've got history repeating itself from the 1811 disaster earthquake, the solar eclipse. It took the exact same path. We've also got some similarities that New York is featuring in this, and many of the sort of events in personnel that have been deployed are in close proximity to New York City. And, as I was sort of trying to say, the eclipse would be a wonderful staging ground. The production value alone of, you know, having the eclipse and the skies darkened, and then all of a sudden there's a sort of sun, you know, comes back out, crafts descend from the skies and land on various places around the Earth. What's this? Missing 1923 actor Cole brings plenty. Is this just broken? What's happened here? I can't hear you still.
Sorry, I have a very unruly 7-year-old. Sorry, I was like totally listening to what you were saying. I just had that up. That was up for a minute. I don't know what.
Well, whatever tomorrow will bring, I guess. But so many weird goings on right now. There was something else I was thinking of that I was going to mention regarding this, but it's lost me at the moment.
Well, this is what I wanted to talk about out of Axios World. Henry Frey, Bill O'Connor, Rebecca, Break the Spell, everybody, JT, thanks for all y'all joining us. And if you shared us out, thank you, like double, triple. But Axios, you know, it's like they go by it, like whatever. But the solar eclipse, why some will stay inside and some meditate. Why some will stay inside and meditate instead of watch. I mean, look, if this doesn't tell you, and I hate to say it, I really do hate to say it, because I'm not a big fan of any man, but definitely not of Matt. But, you know, this makes shit look like it's not real. The reality is not very real. Okay, why some will stay inside and meditate instead of watch? Because why? This shit's so old. It's played out like the Jerry Curl. That's a musical lyric. I'm not being racist. This is crazy. So in the path of totality, they are saying telling people to stay inside, like Texas, Arkansas, like up through that path that we looked at earlier. However, like it's going through 15 states. So we should have subscribers here that could get some footage of this shit. Because I want to see what the F's going on. The sun ain't 93 million miles away. If it was, it would not be able to be covered up by the moon. I don't care what anyone says. It doesn't make sense. It's usually not true, and it doesn't make sense. But this article, mainstream media, Smith Month, instead of going outside and look into the sky during a total eclipse on April 8th, 4-8, y'all, 4-8, 224. So we got triple fours and 1-8. You know, 88. What is it? What day? RD gigawatts?
1.21 gigawatts.
Gigawatts, but the
88 miles an hour.
Yes, thank you. The 88 is in that movie. Two movies.
One of them. That was the speed you needed to get up.
Yes.
And once you got to that speed, you needed the 1.21 gigawatts to boom, to use through a time.
Exactly. But it says the big picture. For centuries, people have turned to rituals. Guys, they don't give a fuck no more. They're telling us what's going on. All right. If you can't see it, I can't help you. For centuries, people have turned to rituals and mythology to honor and make sense of the solar eclipse. You ain't going to make sense because it's a lie. Perception is everything, and they have done so good at culture creation and like spewing everyone's like rationality. Very few true souls, even though you are all, if you're on here for on purpose or true souls, very few people will get it. Very few people will get it this time. They're not going to get it. And I do agree with that. But anyways, zoom in. Members of the Navajo Nation. Cherokee's better, but traditionally treat the solar eclipse as a sacred time to stay inside and quietly meditate. Henry Fowler, a math educator at the Navajo Technical University, tells Axios. So he's already talking to, like, you know, mainstream shit. I'll give him a link. Do you want to watch this just real cute, like, diversity video? An eclipse and like Native American, half-assed Native American video. Here's the path. Pardon me if people want to see the path. Do you want to watch it, partner?
Yes, let's go ahead.
All right. It's not, I can't see, but it's not long. Let's check it out. Guys, give us a sound check, please, in the chat.
A phenomenon that has not taken place in the United States in 7 years, and it's not going to happen again for another two decades. We are talking about the solar eclipse. The path of totality spans from Mexico through Texas across the U.S. towards the Northeast. While those cities in its path will experience total darkness for a few minutes, people here in the Bay Area aren't going to get to see the total eclipse. They'll instead see a partial eclipse. But there are still events being planned across the Bay Area to really talk all things eclipse. And Rosemary, we don't have to wait till Monday. There's an event today with an interesting discussion about its cultural significance.
Yes, Claudine. Okay, so the much-anticipated solar eclipse, as we know, is Monday. There's an event today in San Francisco aimed at educating families about the eclipse and the various cultural meanings behind it. It's at the Red Poppy Art House Mission, or in the Mission. That's where we find a NASA solar eclipse ambassador, Luana Melnick Dos Anjos. Want to make sure I say that properly. Hi, Luana. Good morning.
Hi, good morning, everybody.
Thank you for joining us. So, Luana, I think it's very interesting to note that throughout history, for some, this eclipse is kind of considered a disruption of natural order, and in some cases, a bad omen. And I love this idea of exploring the meaning of the eclipse in regard to different cultures. So let's start with one that is near and dear to your heart, the beliefs and thoughts for those that, or at least for some, that live in Brazil.
Hi, Rosemary. Thank you so much for having me here today.
Sure.
So the Guarani Kaiowá in Brazil, they actually view an eclipse with fear. Their experience of an eclipse over time has brought the belief that the moon during a total solar eclipse may bleed. And if drops of that blood fall on the imperfect village, it might be the end of everything. So they keep JC, Jaguarovi, a blue dog, under a hammock that will potentially leak the drops of this blood, and the shamans will do their rituals and dance, and that is in the effort to integrate this fear, and that children are not allowed to look at the eclipse, And so tranquility returns to the Tekoha, which is the indigenous home.
Wow, that is so interesting. So for many of us, we're thinking, okay, the moon is going to pass between, you know, the sun and the earth, and we get to see this cool eclipse. But for so many cultures, it's so much more. Can you share maybe one or two more?
Soren,
the video, or if we got a streaming buffering issue,
folks will learn there today.
Absolutely. Yeah, so the Mayan culture, according to Milner, and by the way, Ana Carolina Guarani Kaiowa was the person who have shared this tradition from Brazil with me. And Milner, from a Mayan tradition, has shared that during a total solar eclipse, the Mayans believe that the sun will be completely eaten by the moon. And when that happens, they have a big fear around that, and that they believe that kitchen utensils will come to life and will eat people. And so in that sense, what they do is they make a lot of noise so that in what will happen there,
close proximity to that,
scare away the moon and the sun will begin to shine again. And what we also have is a tradition shared by Greg Castro from the Ramaytush Ohlone Association, which is the unceded land which we are standing on, and that shares the eclipse. It's not only a time where we gather materials for basket making and for also a really
Go back a second, sweet cheeks.
Interconnectedness.
Go back a second.
In nature.
About 10 seconds.
It is not only an option. And what we also have is a tradition.
A basket of what looked like blue bonnets,
which is the unceded land which we are standing on.
And wait, what's that now?
Yeah.
It's not only a
They are blue bonnet flowers, which are prevalent, and they only spring up for 3 weeks, and that's it. But they're really, really beautiful, and like the people of Texas and up along this corridor that get blue bonnets, which is, you know, the alphabet, which is a 22.
It's also blue bean.
And
blue, in Texas,
there's so many things, but this is the blue bonnet. And we got the monarch. We have a monarch as well.
Lots going on there. Lots going on, but they've also got festivals for the blue bonnets in Texas at the moment. In some of those places,
they do. But I feel like most people that go to those don't know even what they're going to. They just
they probably don't. Some of those things.
Pro where I live thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, people just do it without knowing. It's just an event, like to maybe get drunk.
But I believe the event coordinators are like succubuses, and they get those people that come there unwillingly, like they don't know it's a true story, or they wouldn't sign up for the shit. I believe they get them too.
Yeah,
guys, very careful. You got to be careful what you participate in.
An energy harvest. It's interesting that she would have mentioned the Mayans and Chichen Itza, because, like, I'm only about 25 minutes away from Chichen Itza, and currently reside in what was once the Mayan land. That was quite interesting. But that was what I wanted to point out, that the blue bonnet.
Yes, that's hot, RD. Let's move on. I'm just kidding. Way cool.
But the blue bonnets, because they have featured in
Cali, Canada. You deserve to live where you are living, especially you did it all on your own. I'm just saying, don't brag, okay? It's still like 30 degrees here in the morning.
I know. I used to want to die or kill for heat during the colder months in my time in Canada. But, you know, that is my neighborhood nowadays. Once upon a time, I lived close to Niagara. Now I live close to the pyramid.
That's what's up.
Time where we gather materials for basket making and for also a really important time to realize the interconnectedness between us.
See, I think there's a whole thing going on with the eclipse. I don't believe that the moon, as a celestial body that they presented as, can go in front of the sun as the celestial body as they present it as, you know, and create this effect. I don't buy it for a second. Not another second. Not a one, not a millisecond. But that's just me. So there's the first deception. Then we're running glasses, then we're going to da-da. Y'all, they will make money off of us however they can. That's how I feel about it. It's just my opinion, not necessarily my partners or those with Shit Video Productions. Just saying. Me, L, my opinion.
We will pay for our execution eventually.
Man, can I pay for it now?
Yeah, I've got mine on installments.
I'm ready to go.
In nature. And so it is not only an opportunity to remember that, but to...
Oh my gosh. When you played that clip in your earlier video, that video was great. I even left a comment. This video is so great. Where the guy was like, I can't believe I even have to say this. But, and he slams him down on the thing. You have to wear your like, he even couldn't believe it. Like, he knew it was bullshit. The dude knew. The police commissioner knew it was bullshit.
I noticed a couple of the sort of reports and the reporters in some of those articles sort of acting as though I can't believe I'm reporting on this.
Yeah.
I think there was that sassy blonde chick. She's like, I can assure you, you're not going to see anything with the glasses. And you can even sort of see her like trying to wince behind the simulation of the eclipse with the boards. But there's been a comedy factor in whatever happens tomorrow.
I'm sorry, what factor?
Comedy factor.
I love comedy. What is
it? Is it going to be a tragic comedy, a dark comedy, or are we all laughing? Oh, what did everyone get? Those military exercises were nothing. They really were just re-logisticating.
I just hope it's a calamity. Just come on already. Like, this is, I can't stand the anxiety of it all. Like, I wish we just, like, do it. Shit or get off the pot. Like, that's the kind of school I grew up in.
I would imagine quite a lot of people are in a very similar sort of state of anxiety at the moment. Not everybody, but a lot of these messages are being delivered from the mainstream, so it's sort of going to get a wide audience. It's not like we're showing videos from sort of other YouTubers with, a couple of thousand subscribers at most and a handful of views that are sort of suggesting.
What's happening, though? Like, they used to get suggested, like, back in the day, and people would take it for what it was worth. But now, like, it's like people don't even take the videos of what we showed in, like, the first... And then we showed the same. Point being, time, they say time heals all wounds. Well, it's the direct opposite. Time inflicts the most heinous wounds. Death, even, by 1,000 cuts. This is so evil. I can't believe I didn't see it sooner. I'm 45. At least I saw it by now. I guess I'm a little slow. They told me I don't want to. I thought I was smart, They told me. But let's just watch the end of this. So can we do that? It's almost.
Yeah, done. Let's do that. I just wanted to point that out.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yes.
As tours of our land. And so I really love this cultural weaving of the
science
that will potentially leak the drops of this blood, and the shamans will do their rituals and dance, and that is in the effort to integrate this fear, and that children are not allowed to look at the eclipse, and so tranquility returns to the Decoded.
So I want to ask everybody that's watching now in the chat, everybody that's watching subsequently, who has the balls to do it, and my partner, who thinks that if a child is under 16 years old, I just feel like the United States of America doesn't have any rites of passages for men or for children in general to go through. Is it really that bad to get beat on your ankle? Like, doesn't everybody get beat? Doesn't every woman get raped? Like, seriously, like, it's just so out of the way, and that's what they choose to like focus their attention on. So, you know, it's so disingenuous.
Coha, which is the indigenous home.
Wow, that is so interesting. So for many of us, we're thinking, okay,
I'm for it. I'll break your leg if you have a beautiful count. It's like a thing. Like
the moon is going to pass between, you know, the sun and the earth, and we get to see this cool eclipse. But for so many cultures, it's so much more. Can you share maybe one or two more of what folks will learn there today?
Absolutely. Yeah. So the Mayan culture, according to Milner, and by the way, Ana Carolina Guarani.
My partner can speak to this. He's down in the Yucatan Peninsula. And partner, please do speak to this lady thing.
Kaiwa was the person.
Run into her or like?
Well, it, you know, like after she's done talking, let me know what you think of her. You know,
as an individual, she's interesting to look at.
I disagree. I think she's very disinteresting to look at, but we'll listen.
From Brazil with me, and Milner from a Mayan tradition has shared that during a total solar eclipse, the Mayans believe that the sun will be completely eaten by the moon. And when that happens, they have a big fear around that, and that they believe that kitchen utensils will come to life and will eat people.
Yeah. This is so subversive. That is not true. That is not the lore, folklore, even if you want to call it. This bitch is doing a disservice. Not even a disservice. She's lying about what's going on here. This is sick. Oh my God.
And so in that sense, oh, what they do is they make a lot of noise so that in what will happen there is that with the noise will scare away the moon and the sun will begin to shine again. And what we also have is a tradition shared by Greg Castro from the Ramaytush Ohlone Association, which is the unceded land which we are standing on, and that shares the
why doesn't she just be like, Ishtar, can you stop making it rain?
The eclipse is not only a time where we gather materials for basket making and for also a really important time to realize the interconnectedness between us and nature. And so it is not only an opportunity to remember that, but to take our place.
And remember to get your NASA approved eclipse glasses, people.
Now make sure you stand 6 feet away from the next person that's watching the eclipse, because you don't want to get their catch the radiation that might affect their irises.
Yeah, they need us all to get the same amount of radiation, so let's help them out, right? There's the link to that. Oh my gosh, partner.
Yeah, the kitchen utensils, that was quite interesting.
I mean, are you kidding me? I almost threw up. But
although,
luckily, I haven't eaten anything all day, so.
Yeah, I mean, she might, the Mayans do have a sort of.
The Mayans are dead. After 2012, ain't no more Mayans. That's what they said, and that's what it is.
But maybe they just were taking the piss out of her. They like, oh my God, we got a fucking live one. Look at this fucking chick that thinks she's a guy. Tell her about the utensils. Tell her we used to believe. And then she'll tell all her friends. And don't put that past them. You know what I mean?
Oh, you multi-wooden spoon. I love you so. You mix my pasta up in my bowl. It's a beautiful thing. I love you, my wooden spatula.
Spatula city.
Anyway, I did want to speak about this. A woman, 28 years of age, euthanasia, rather than living with mental illness. Guys, look, I don't know how my partner feels about this, and I'm open to hearing, of course, hearing about it. I'm open to all avenues, not just alternative, any different way of thinking. Woman, 28, age 28, y'all. Opts, if you believe this myth, okay, opts for euthanasia rather than living with mental illness. Quote, it doesn't get better. All right, bitch, ain't nobody likes to get better. And oh, of course it gets worse. Because you have responsibility and you get jaded. Like, okay, so you get to die. And Dr. Kevorkian, I think we should do a special on him, partner.
Who is he? He's the euthanasia.
He's the one that, like, served time for doing this, and now they're okaying it.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, funny enough, you asked my thoughts on it. Last year, or maybe actually 2 years ago, I did a stream called Canadian Crisis, when the laws in Canada had just been opened to include mental health of any kind. And mental health is a very, very long, wide umbrella.
And big spectrum, and like anybody can, like any doctor can say any like mental health thing, and you
qualify for medical assistance in death. Yeah. And during that stream, I suggested that, and the other thing that they included include is that children under the age of 16 can apply for it without consent from their parents. And I suggested at the time that, you know, when we're young, 17 or in our 20s, and we have a boyfriend or a girlfriend who dumps us, that is the most tragic moment of our life. If you've never been dumped, when you get dumped, nothing hurts like that. And each and every one of us,
everybody has to kind of go through that. That's like a rite of passage. Americans are so pussy. Not just Americans, but Americans especially. Like, of course you're going to go through that. The first person you love is not going to work out.
the first person you love is going to hurt you the most, usually, right? In the pain.
Right.
But we've all gone through that breakup phase where we don't want to live anymore. I mean, some people actually do go to the extremities of doing that. I've actually known a couple of friends back home that opted out after their partners decided to move on and find somebody else. One tragically, so he got drunk and fell asleep in a crop field during the harvest season, and chopped him up. Bless his soul. But anyway, you know, that is something now that teenagers in Canada can wake up one day during a breakup, not wanting to go on anymore, can go to their doctor. I'm depressed. I want medical assistance in death. And rather than
teenagers without their fucking parents' consent. This is why it takes a fucking village. And if y'all look into like that whole thing, and all the young global leaders, and Justin Trudeau is one of them. I mean, they're all in on it. If you look into it, you will see that it's just an evil way for us to do their job. Okay? There's the link. It's an evil way for us to do their fucking job. Let them do it themselves. Like, if they want to do it Yeah. So this is what I just shared in the chat. Sorry if I wasn't sharing.
And you had the sort of, I referenced the movie Soylent Green, the euthanasia clinics for depression.
Yes, people.
Were very pivotal to that plot. And of course, it was the euthanasia clinic that provided the bodies for the Soylent Green Corporation to reprocess the corpse into Soylent Green that was then distributed every Tuesday. Soylent Green is a people, if you haven't seen that movie. But the other movie that this reminds me of is Logan's Run, where you're only allowed to live up until 30. And this girl being 28 is...
And this is a script that we see played and played out again, guys, because they don't... If it ain't broke, they don't fix it. Trust me. What my partner was just saying, like, that's a common theme in a lot of different movies or shows or whatever.
Yeah, covered in many genres. But, you know, at the time that this announcement was made in Canada, there was like a sort of propaganda campaign to sort of make the idea of opting out for depression or poverty. And they kind of say,
a good is thing. A good thing. Oh, if you're poor,
yeah, they were making it a good thing.
Or if you're sick, just kill yourself.
They even have commercials, I believe.
Kill yourself.
I think I caught one during that stream, but not living in Canada anymore, I couldn't...
Unalive yourself, I meant. Sorry.
But, you know, they were pushing it, and they were sort of saying that, you know, poverty is depressing, and this qualifies you for medical assistance and death. Rather than live in poverty and on benefits, just die. It's a much better option. Just die. And they had a few sort of crisis actors that were playing the parts of homeless people. Yeah, you know, I'm really considering it. I only have like $20 a week to live off of, and, you know, dying is much better than... And when they start selling you the idea, people will adopt the idea. Yeah, I sort of grew up on a lot of these movies, Forever Flowers, and sort of we'll rewatch them over and over again on video. I used to take them off of the TV or in the days before you could sort of afford to buy VHS cassettes. Yeah, they actually changed it. It was first MAD, medical assisted death, but then they've changed it to medical assistance in death. But that is something that is now legalized in Canada, and if you are a sufferer of mental health disorders, then
you just kill yourself.
Yeah, you are eligible. No need to take Prozac, although maybe killing yourself softly as opposed to a quick injection.
Prozac, yeah, Prozac's a pill, or fluoxetine is a generic. That's death by a thousand cuts too. They all are. They all are, guys. All the meds are.
I'm just gonna get a drop of water.
Just a drop. It's very good to see you, We Free. Very good to see you, D. Nice. Bill O'Connell, repent. Politicians are all pirates and devil worshippers. Yeah, I agree. We Free, very good to see you. We Free has a channel. Very good channel. I don't know shit, man. Look. Where's the knower of nothing? Where's our things at?
There they are.
Yeah, he's the knower of nothing and adjuster of junk, and I'm the disobeyer and bullshit player. Slayer, bullshit slayer. But yeah. A wise man knows he knows nothing at all. So
Nothing at all.
Well, we don't know. She
actually, that's something I haven't done and should have done. Let's look if there's a Simpsons Eclipse reference.
Ooh, I love it. Yes, D-Nice, exactly.
And of course there is. Maggie Gone Mad.
So sick, Cam.
Oh, no, Maggie Gone. The Simpsons
Gone, arts. Maggie Gone. Love is gone, it's gone, Maggie Gone. That's a play on a Violent Femme song.
Yeah, I guess so, although I'm not familiar with that, but they do play on movie titles.
Very familiar.
softer pop culture. That was what I was trying to say.
Bring it out.
I don't think it's going to reveal anything too, but what don't...
I can't see how it won't.
Let's find out. Wherever there's an event, let's go to the Simpsons.
Let's go to the Eclipse. I that's not like my first go-to, but this is a big deal. This is on par with 2017 and everything that happened. It was low-key shit from 2017 till Kobe's crash. And then Kovisha came to visit, and it was hardcore shit until now. So, yes, it does serve good to go back and look at these things. And you're sharing your screen, so just, blow it up and let's do it.
I think this is Wikipedia, yeah. The episode is the 13th episode of the...
Ooh, God, what's that red box around it? Oh, is Wikipedia even hating on The Simpsons?
No, they want me to give them some money. Don't they? Oh,
fuck them. No.
But this is interesting. It is the 13th episode of the 20th season. So what do you get if you add 13 to 20? Anyone? Bueller?
I have it. It's 9. That's the number of finality. It's the last base number, 1 through 9, and then they repeat.
But this is the plot.
More interesting than that are the two numbers separately.
You're more of a whiz with the numbers than I am. I'm not good with numbers.
My dad's a retired CPA. He would disagree. He thinks I'm a loser when it comes to numbers.
But the Simpsons are excited for a solar eclipse over Springfield. And after Homer's camera breaks, Marge gives up her own, and the family expresses delight at seeing the eclipse. Marge takes a peek, which blinds her. Dr. Hibbert, I think I can remember this episode, actually.
Yeah. The black doctor.
If I might, doesn't Homer have to attend to and be kind?
Where's the link? Play the episode.
There's no episode link. This is just on Wikipedia.
I'll grab it.
After Marge's eyes must be covered for 2 weeks, and she must not be put under any stress. And after a rat Homer takes Maggie and Santa's little helper to buy rat poison. And on the way home, the baby and the dog's bickering causes the car to fall off a bridge.
Do we have a year? What season is this?
Season 20. I think we're on like season 39 now, so this is probably 20 years old. It might give us a release date at the bottom. I think I can see it. Episode, how interesting. A bridge, an eclipse, and blindness. The goggles will do nothing, which is another Simpsons reference, and blind who wears them.
6 years ago, it was uploaded. We have a solar eclipse. Do you want to see it? Let's watch.
All righty. And we've been going 2.5 hours. So 30 minutes longer than our
You need Verizon. Get the new iPhone 15 Pro with tons of storage. So you can take all the...
I said we've been going for like 2.5 hours.
Yeah, okay. We'll get off right
now. But yeah, we can wrap it up shortly.
Great way to end it, I think. Is with the Simpsons. Oh shit. Did you hear the Mexican
mayor? Yeah.
For centuries, man has been ruled by science and industry, but that
is drawing
to a close.
A sea wave?
We stand on the cusp of a new epoch, one of prophecy, puzzles, and signs in the sky. And that epoch begins today.
Epoch.
our top story. Today, Springfield will experience a rare total eclipse of the sun.
Nara.
The solar eclipse is like a woman breastfeeding in a restaurant. It's free, it's blue, but under no circumstances should you
look. This is from the days when the Simpsons was good.
And he just threw up the, it's a Rockefeller. He threw up the pyramid. I mean, what's going on here? This is, I had no idea. No idea.
Free, it's beautiful, but under no circumstances should you look at it. We recommend using a homemade camera obscura fashioned from an ordinary shoebox and paper towel tube. This was supposed to be pre-made. Fine, I'll do it myself. Where's the end of the freaking tape? Forget it. We'll do it next week.
The eclipse is today.
There's an eclipse when I say there's an eclipse.
Wow, look at that.
Oh, look at the Tesla. And a train.
They're both. I'm not even going to speak.
Okay, people, we've hit penumbra. Brace yourself for umbra. I'm going to see it first.
No, I'm going to see it first.
Hit the road, you big load.
My space toy.
Oh, it's okay, homie. You can have my viewer.
Fuck
Mom,
Audrey.
You'll miss the eclipse. There'll be another one in North Yemen in 2027. We have totality, people.
Hey, Jamie. Can me and RD get a fact check on that?
We'll be talking about this together for
2027. Jamie, or who's Roseanne's bitch? Oh, it's her son. Let me not talk bad about her son, but can we get a Jamie? Somebody check. What's going on
2027? We have.
There's another one in Yemen in 2027.
Let's look
we'll
that
be
up.
Talking about this together for years.
For years.
I finally feel like part of a family.
Oh, I can't miss out. Just one little peek. It's beautiful.
Now, Marge, your eyes must stay completely covered for 2 full weeks.
Don't worry, honey. I'll be your seeing eye, Homer. We're in some kind of doctor room. Bunch of stuff on the walls. It's kind of hard to describe. I'm going to take my break now.
Now, Simpsons, I must warn you. Any stress could increase the blood pressure in Marge's eyeballs, leading to what we call Tex Avery syndrome.
Wolves are taking all our women.
Can you imagine them making this
like
today?
Princess.
No, you can't. Because they would never make that. They would never allow that today. I mean, I don't know. I don't have cable. I haven't had a cable. I don't have a TV. But that is insane. What a good Simpsons episode.
It was, and from the days when The Simpsons was good. I haven't watched it for many, many years, but I used to religiously watch it and save it and record it on
tapes.
Binge watch it when I used to get stoned. That was one of my favorite things, getting stoned and watching endless episodes of The Simpsons.
But were they women that threw the stones? Were you buried up to your neck in the sand when they threw the stones?
No, they just tied me to a post.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Tied you to a post. Wow. I just have some food here.
Brian, we haven't seen you for such a time. Where have you been, Brian Griffin? Didn't end just yet, my friend. Let's hope it doesn't end any time soon. But with all the unprecedented activities that has been going on leading up to this event, and with the revelation that there is a large-scale military exercise going on, in conjunction with this eclipse. We've already had an eclipse, an earthquake, aftershocks, and further earthquakes. Emergency acts are in place, declarations of disaster. All I'm going to say is it looks as though something's going to go on. We don't know what will go on until tomorrow. Hopefully.
And even, let me just say this, sorry to cut you off, but even like if it doesn't happen tomorrow, things can happen tomorrow that may affect things
a few days or weeks later.
Right.
As was the case in 11. But I am inclined to think that maybe tomorrow is a ground zero event is the fact that so much is going on, especially having a military exercise, military personnel deployed in New York City where they've already had an earthquake. Keep repeating it, but there are over 60 states, counties. I don't know about states exactly, but I'm sure some of those might extend statewide states of emergency, because obviously not the whole entire state will be covered by the eclipse in some of these incidents. But over 60 cities now technically under emergency powers, and with emergency powers that can extend without any effort into martial law. The military moving equipment is disturbing. And, you know, when we were talking on Friday about this and you, in the earthquake, and you said that you first thought that what you heard was a helicopter, and the fact that there are the helicopters that you thought you heard being used as part of a military exercise in an airport is 40 minutes away from you. That suggests to me that's probably what you heard. There was another report that I saw of an individual that said that the earthquake felt and sounded like bombs going off. Maybe he did hear bombs going off, and he also admitted he didn't know it was an earthquake until after the alert come out and told everybody that it's an earthquake. And he was in the area where military are carrying out exercises. Guys, I'm not being an alarmist. I'm not being a fear porn. I'm just stating the facts as we have presented them to you, and things that we've heard, things that we've seen, and things that we've shared in these streams about the eclipse. And you cannot deny that this is beyond fucking batshit crazy, and they've gone to so much great lengths and trouble. I can't think it is going to go to waste. So tomorrow is going to be interesting. I'm not sure how long my partner has stepped away for, but the sun, funny enough, is beginning to descend where I am in this world, part of the world. And as my partner said, it would be a great way to end this show on that little Simpsons eclipse. So when or not my partner comes back, I guess we will commence with the outro pleasantries. And then I think rather on this occasion, playing you out with the dancing girl, I may put a request to my partner if she would be so kind as to play us out with a specially themed eclipse intro that can also serve as an outro in this instance, and as sort of the CEO of Chip Video Productions. Just a humble request there. But it does look as though we have lost my partner for the time being. So if she's got some mum life or feeding the dog or whatever, hopefully she returns before too long. But let's see if you guys are mentioning anything in the chat. Joy, martial law is in effect. Make no mistake. And the sheepdog patriot says, hey joy, let's take a sad song and make it crapper. Rob, I thought Max Ingram went to BitChute. I should check out other platforms. I've never really watched BitChute or Odyssey. I did actually apply to have Reality Decoded added to Odyssey, but Odyssey rejected it for some reason. Now I can't start a channel on there under that email. Partner, where are you, my darling? Bill, I'm heading to the
I just need 1 minute. 60 no problem. Seconds.
I'm heading to the FOJ Radio Remnant Underground Church YouTube channel. I thought you were going to an underground bunker for a minute then, which would have been pretty cool, and I wouldn't blame you, all things considered, Bill, to be honest there, folks. It might be the time to duck and cover, or while you can get out of Dodge if you are in the totalitary zone of the eclipse, and you can always go back if nothing happens and laugh and joke about it at the time. Oh my God, remember when we got so scared about the eclipse and we bugged out temporarily for 3 days? Or you don't want to risk what may be about to unfold. And I don't know what's going to happen. I know I do need to put some lights on. So let me do that quickly. Sorry, guys.
And I am sorry, Fred.
No, it's all right.
I was brought in a plate of food and I was so hungry I had to eat it.
I don't blame you, but seeing it on that
sorry, team, I had to eat it. It was corn on the cob. Nothing.
That was a sandwich I made.
Tender chicken, and I don't eat. I don't eat. I really don't eat, so yeah.
Well, that's good. We stopped for a food break. You do need your sustenance and nutrients.
I really should eat, yeah.
There was a sandwich I was going to eat before the stream, but didn't get chance to. It's all gone a bit dry and hard.
Why you got to be all the way in Mexico? I want a bite.
There you go. I actually made that myself.
What is that?
It's nothing fancy. It's just cheese, ham, some avocado, and tomato.
See, I don't like ham. It's too salty. It looks blazing.
It is. Yeah, look, quite a few people don't dine on swine, but I am from a town that is
I eat pork. I just don't like ham. I eat bacon.
Yeah, bacon is good. Those are the dinosaurs.
I eat sausage. I
sometimes think if maybe like the Jews and the Muslims chowed down on a plate of bacon, the world would be a better place once they realized how delicious it is. Now get them together, the head rabbi, the head.
I don't know about that.
Who knows? What possibly could go more wrong than is going wrong in the world now with a rabbi in, I don't know what they call them in Islam. Priest, chieftain, I don't know what the top poncho would be example. But folks, tomorrow, as I said, is eclipse day. Hopefully we will be here to cover the eclipse for the duration with eclipse tricks.
Eclipse tricks, eclipse watch. Join us tomorrow. Share it out too.
Yeah, we get it shared a little bit earlier.
Flowers, Daryl, Rebecca, who's very good at sharing. During the Flame Flemic, I noticed too there was this. This is a very little nuance that maybe you didn't notice, partner, but I noticed it. People are putting sharing is spreading. And I was like, no. Sharing is caring. If you share someone's YouTube channel, you're not fucking Covisha. You're not gonna have Covisha knocking at your door because you shared a fucking YouTube channel. So, but that's they did go that way. They went that way. That's how hardcore they went. That's how you know it's not what they say it is. I don't know what it is. I just know it's not what they say it is. That's all I know.
Try to do the opposite of what they are telling you, or at least consider the opposite in the situation that they are telling you in as a possibility.
Thank you, Rebecca.
You have a very good Rebecca. Track of telling us one thing and meaning the other. But I don't know if you did hear my little request. Would you be so kind as to play us out with a special eclipse-themed intro that will
absolutely.
It will double up as an outro as well.
Well, after I play that, can I play the song double up? by Nipsey Hussle.
Why don't you play that one first if you wanted to?
No, I'm just fucking around. I'm not going to do that.
I don't even know what that song is. Although you are born in the 70s.
It wouldn't get us struck. Like, I'm allowed to play it. I played it, but I'm not. I was just totally joking.
Yeah, let's hope we don't get struck down for the Simpsons content.
Bang, bang, he's struck me now. Bang, bang. I hit the ground. Bang, bang. Bang, bang. My baby shot me now. I'm looking right here, right?
For that, someone just dropped a video on the Eclipse. Da, da, da. The time that we reported about Off Grid with Doug and Stacy just dropped a grid video.
I don't fuck with that.
But at the time we did our first stream about the Eclipse, nobody was talking about the Eclipse. And even people that were watching that stream were saying, I'm so glad you guys are covering this because nobody is talking about it.
Eclipse, oh my God, what the fuck?
Shit Video Productions does have a track record of what, my sweet?
Not as shit as you think.
No, it has a track record. I mean, it isn't as shit as you think, but it has a track record of We Told.
I told you so.
Exactly. Let's hope this isn't a We Told You So, but we have.
Told you so. We don't want to be right. We don't want to be right.
Certainly not.
That's like not the point. It's just the point that we happen to be right.
We do want to be wrong. No, but
I love you.
You a lot of information over these Eclipse eyes on the Eclipse reports. Be of concern, and
We will be streaming tomorrow. We will be streaming here on this channel, and we will be doing an Eclipse Tricks Eclipse Watch. So please spread it around, please. And join us here and partner. What time are we going?
That was what I was about to ask you. We need to coordinate in time with the Eclipse.
Well, it goes 1:30. It goes live 1:30 in Texas.
Well, let's plan for 1:30 because that's
one. I'm thinking like 2 o'clock, because then we could play like Dabu in Florida. We could play like some other. We could play some videos that have already been gathered. It's only been a half an hour, so it's not that much. Do you know what I mean?
I do know what you mean, but let me just present to you.
Well, whatever you want to do. We can talk about that later.
I'm down with anything, but
whatever. 1:30, 2 o'clock, we will be here with Eclipse coverage, okay?
We have
Miss B in the house. We've got people all over the world in here. There's a lot of people in here, and there's people in here that aren't even typing. Okay? I don't care. Boots on the ground. If you can safely get footage of this shit, get it.
We can share the link. You can get it. Roving reporter for us with your camera.
Exactly, roving reporter, please. But this is what they base their shit on. It doesn't matter if you believe it or not, okay? They do. So something ill is going to happen.
That's it. But what I was going to suggest, with regards to the time, imagine you and I were streaming in 2001 and we said, hey, let's go down on Tuesday morning and do a World Trade Center watch. Why don't we get there and watch the sun?
Oh, my gosh. I just found a Muhammad Atta passport.
Imagine if you said, yeah, let's do that. But why don't we get down there about 11 o'clock in the morning and set up our cameras? And I'm like, why don't we set up at sunrise? If something's going to happen, it could happen at any given time. It would be nice to be breaking news. This has just happened. 1:30 is, Miss Blanche says it happens. That would be Central or Eastern time, because I'm on Central time at the moment.
I'm sorry. Did you ask me?
But yeah, why don't we figure it out 1:30-ish, I guess. We can come on and then if
totally.
Unless something happens, we can jump into action earlier.
Yeah, absolutely. It's not like we don't have like mad content to play too. So yeah, you guys really aren't gonna find like there's some good channels out there, but they're few and far between these days. With YouTube the way it is, and we're probably not gonna be around that much longer neither with all the new regulations, I suspect before 2026. But thank you all. Pardon me, we free sheepdog Daryl, Brian, FF for Flowers, Miss Blanche. I just want to thank everybody for being here, and that's all. So I just want to really thank everyone for their participation in the chat and speaking on topic in the chat. Like, that's very important to me. It means a lot to me when people speak about what we're actually talking about, you know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. We always appreciate contextual comments and contributions from our viewers as much as possible. But with that being said, all that remains for me to do and say is until next time, folks, remember to take care. And tomorrow will be the next time. And it is a day that you should probably be taking a lot of care on, all things considered, and given the information we have presented to you. But as I said, take care until the next time. May the force be with us all. And more importantly, be excellent to each other. We forgot that, man. Oh, shame on me. But cue Bonnie Tyler, and let's play out with some classical piano and eclipse-related fear porn. RD, signing out for now.
Love my partner. Love the eclipse-related fear porn. Let's do it. Peace out, friends. You can only prep so much, okay? Don't go cry. Don't bug. Whatever's gonna happen is gonna happen, okay? Let me take this banner off. Sorry. See you in the next one. RIP DJ Davey Krakow and Mike Morales. And we will see you in the next one, guys. Thank you for joining us at Shit Video Production.
Why all of these states of emergency around the country?
We understand in the state of emergency, Sergeant Fifield, that all officers, even if they're detectives, have been called to the street in anticipation of this.
Travis County leaders have already issued a disaster declaration to ensure first responders are able to better manage what's to come.
Texas County issued a disaster declaration to try to prepare for the solar eclipse.
It says it is enacting the state of emergency out of an abundance of caution, as it has been working with partners to ensure April 8th runs as smoothly as possible.
Next up, it's Coryell County, who has issued a local disaster declaration all ahead of the solar eclipse on Monday. The county is expecting up to 200,000 visitors. That would cause a real burden on the infrastructure there. Disruption of cellular and internet services as well, and grocery and fuel shortages can be expected. Residents are urged to have sufficient food and groceries for days leading up to and post the big event.
We will be activating the city's Emergency Operations Center here in City Hall, as well as a joint information center.
At a joint news conference Tuesday, city leaders said the focus is on fun and public safety.
We're going to continue to do more to the city of Dallas. We're going to do more in District 4. And here is the celebration.
Dallas coverage may be a challenge that day. While we are surging resources in terms of additional coverage, and while we are basically expanding the bandwidth that 911 could use, it is possible that cell phones get a bit overloaded. If that happens, remember that 911 will continue to work. 911 works even when our cell phone grid is overloaded. but only use 911 for true emergencies. Being stuck in traffic, if you are okay, is not a true emergency.
Just a precaution, the whole disaster declaration to make sure our first responders and public safety officials are able to better manage traffic and crowds.
As the once-in-a-lifetime total eclipse looms over the city of Dallas, officials say it's all hands on deck.
Everybody that we have that is sworn personnel that wears a uniform at some point in time will be out working that day. But as you said, the governor declared a state of emergency. We're not the only state that did that, but it's just in preparation for the literally hundreds of thousands of folks that we're anticipating coming into our state on Monday.
And small are preparing for the eclipse on Monday. And as of today, we've got our first East Texas county declaring a disaster for the weekend of the event.
The Arkansas Division of Emergency Management is still shooting high, telling me they are preparing for a surge of visitors. But whether it's a couple hundred thousand or more than a million, they want to remind everyone the total solar eclipse is a huge draw and historic event. We can see that sentiment here. The last time we checked in with Adam, the number of events planned throughout the state sat at 95. It's now 137, with the possibility of growing. Eric Eckhoff, the operations specialist with the Division of Emergency Management, says another thing that's changed are their coordination calls. They were holding those monthly, and that has turned into weekly calls involving local coordinators and emergency support function groups. As they prepare, they want Arkansans to do the same. Prepare to be on the road longer due to traffic. Have necessities on hand like water, snacks, and cash. Also, something you might not think of, cell service can be spotty.
In less than a week, Central Texas will be in the path of totality for the upcoming solar eclipse on April 8th.
We get a front row seat and the best view of this wonderful historic event.
What we've been seeing is an advanced case of what I call moon madness. In other words, lunacy. And there are two reasons, at least, for that lunacy. First of all, people are getting older, and they have a bucket list. And on that bucket list, before they kick the bucket, is they want to see a total eclipse of the sun, to be part of the universe. And second of all, we have to realize that people want to be part of this larger tapestry called the universe.
Coming celestial occurrence could outdo them all.
Frankly, the solar eclipse is a big one.
All right, so here we go. Tens of thousands of people are expected to visit the Metroplex next week to view the total solar eclipse in totality.
Okay, I put my glasses on. Okay, because I don't want my retinas to get burned.
Correct.
See nothing with these on.
Right, because they're like welder's glasses.
Yes, I'm going to keep my...
I got to put my glasses on too here.
Well, you're not going to be able to see anything. I'm telling you that right now.
I'm going to guess here. So at about 10 to 1...
Yes.
Central time, we're going to have the moon start to do the eclipse here. And about an hour into it, you're going to get the full eclipse. And then it's going to pass on.
Okay.
So hopefully we didn't ruin it for everybody there.
No, hopefully we didn't.
Excitement is building for Monday's solar eclipse. And as you probably know, you're not supposed to look directly at it without proper glasses. But buyer beware. There are some specs out there that don't protect your eye.
My eyes, the goggles do nothing.
All of these emergency declarations this time. What is going on?